Let's get ready to send it! Nitro Cross is yours at Quiet Track Death Thrill.
This is Motocross for the Wolf.
We're talking dirt track, bigger jump.
Don't doubt us. Believe in it.
Oh, there's a row!
Don't tell your mom we're gonna go bigger.
Welcome back to Utah Motorsports Campus. Day two of a doubleheader weekend, and day one was won by this man, Travis Pastrana. Dude, you gotta love this course, man. You say you're not good on the asphalt, but obviously you put it all together.
Well, we added more pavement. Luckily, my teammate Connor Martel was on fire all day, taking the top qualifier, helping me through the pavement. We got really lucky, but I'd rather be lucky than good. Hopefully gonna be a lot of fun today sending it. Everyone is so close. Fraz wins round one, doesn't qualify for round two. It's anyone's game.
Oh man, I mean, you talk about how good Connor Martel is, but again, you put it all together. A star-studded cast. We've seen wind, we've seen lightning, we've seen rain, but who's gonna put lightning in a bottle? I'm Jared Dean. I'm gonna be your tour guide, but let's throw it to other members of our broadcast team. Of course, Mr. Mega, Andrew Coley, and join us here this weekend, Diana Dahlgren. They're down in the paddock now.
Such a great time yesterday here at Utah Motorsports Campus. Just tons going on in the paddock, as well as the amazing action out on track. How did you find it?
I had an absolute blast yesterday. There's just so much going on, action-packed day from start to finish. Not only that, but it's very cool seeing amazing personalities, famous people out here. We got guys like Cowboy Cerrone deciding to race. We also got Cletus McFarland here this weekend, and we have guys like Blake Bulkey here. So just the mass variety of personalities here racing, it's exciting.
Yeah, tons of stuff to do in the paddock. We had the full-on Nitro Circus show, and of course, out on track, the four main classes. We've got Baja Bugs, we've got side-by-side, we've got NRX Next, and we've got Group E. If you don't know what any of that means, take a look at this.
So this is how the gnarliest motorsport on the planet works. Group E is the top dog, all electric formula, full superstar drivers, like these guys. We start with qualifying. The further you get, the better you start on the grid later on. The driver who is fastest in qualifying is the top qualifier, the TQ, and gets to wear the TQ belt. You also get a cute little TQ sticker, which they get to put on the side of the car. Fighter Ace Top Gun style. We're then off to the meat of the event, the multi-car races. First up, we have the three semifinals where the winners go through. But if you haven't found your mojo just yet, you get one more shot in the LCQ, the last chance qualifiers, where the top two advance to the final. Of course, the first to take the checkered flag is the winner of the event. And the guy at the end of the year with the most points, of course, is your Nitro Cross Global Champion. Didn't get any of that because you're looking at your phone. All you really need to know is Nitro Cross is gnarly.
And that's how it all works here at Nitro Cross. We're here in the family room. I'm feeling comfortable. I'm feeling cool. It is hot. I'll be honest. It is hot. So we got a little air con. Flies are circling, but the cars are flying as well. Coley, lay of the land, what are your thoughts coming into day two?
Great day yesterday, loved seeing the cars under the lights, seeing the brake disc glowing, the gap jump. This place is special, of course, again, going right back to 2018 where it all started. It just felt cool to come home, I think.
Yep, absolutely. Let's take a look overall. This is our lay of the land on Group E going into Baja Bugs. Next, side-by-sides, Group E. And we kind of, chop it up with the warm-ups, the heats, all that action, unraveling here at Utah Motorsports Campus. Group E, we got semifinals. We'll walk you through how it all works. If this is your first time, if this is your 100th time, it is always great to take a look at again. Let's take a look at yesterday's final under the lights. Wow. I got to tell you, Travis Pastrana kept saying, I don't know, I'm not good on the asphalt. I'm not good on the pavement. Well, guess what? He kind of was because he took it to the top. But walk us through some kind of your big moments or what we're looking at here.
They tactically was interesting. They put Martel, who was the pole sitter, on the outside. And that would have meant that he did the standard lap first. Travis went to the joke lap. We thought it was going to be to defend position and put Connor in the lead. The car failed here. That meant Backward had to live. Robin Larson hit the back of Backward, and then Ollie Erickson hit the back of Larson. So it was quite a lot of damage through just racing instincts in turn one. This is Ollie Erickson's front end from where he'd hit Larson. He bails before the gap jump. Yep. We're not actually sure whether that was tech or whether he thought, I'm not hitting a 130-foot gap at 74 mile an hour without being able to see where I'm going. And that's fair enough.
Absolutely.
That is fair enough.
And it was so crazy. Such a bummer for Connor Martel. And I joke about Travis saying, hey, man, you didn't do good in asphalt, but, it came together for him. And you know, today even he's talking about his setup, maybe changing it for today into, you know, going into today, because we got a little bit of cloud cover last night. Obviously, there's no sun out. So the conditions are ever changing and they're ever evolving with their settings.
Yeah, conditions change on every lap. Obviously, not so much on the pavement, although we do get the dirt drag there. Obviously, you have to take that into account. Travis always plays down his pavement skills, but yeah, he is a world-class driver. It was a deserved sixth Nitro Cross win for him. He is the winningest driver in the history of this series.
Nice stats. Speaking of stats, this is our Group E Championship standings. Kevin Harrison does assume the lead. Travis Pastrana second, Andreas Backrud, so on and so forth. You see the remaining drivers there and where they stand. But there are so many rounds left here in this championship, and even one today. So let's take a look at qualifying here in day two of this doubleheader action. And you know what?
Didn't go so well for yesterday's winner, Travis Pastrana. Look at this, they've damped the course down. He comes in just a tiny bit hot. He's maybe a car width wide. Up the inside,
Tanner Faust.
Tiny bit of contact. Jared, you spoke to Travis about this.
Yeah, I talked to Travis. He says, you know what? They watered the track properly, but with the cloud cover, it didn't dry out as much as it did yesterday. That he tiptoed in, and then Tanner Faust just came in hot. Now here's our TQ race. You got the Ericsson bros mixed in with a little Backrud sprinkles.
Yeah, so Kevin Ericsson running the new yellow kicker livery this weekend. He goes Joker on the very first lap, so that leaves Ollie Ericsson and Andreas Backrud fighting together. See Kevin come straight out behind them. We know the delta is around 2.2, 2.3 seconds. It varies a bit with track conditions, but look, he's right on the tail of this group. So very next lap, tactically, you've got to decide when you're gonna go. And this time, look, Ollie Ericsson peels off the left-hand side. He goes Joker. So now we know it's a two-car race. Look, yeah. Kevin comes out in front of Ollie, and it's about that gap between him and Andreas Backrud. Backrud left the Joker until the very last lap, and this was the merge.
Kevin Ericsson goes for it. Watch him, Mr. Go round the outside. He shuts the door literally, boom, and figuratively. As you can see it, he gets into the side of Andreas Backrud. He shows him his FC1X badge, and Backrud cannot get past him. So Kevin Ericsson is our TQ belt winner here on day two. Diana Dahlgren caught up with that TQ champ belt holder.
Okay, we are here with Kevin Ericsson, our top qualifier for today. You get the sticker, you get our amazing belt, you get the 12 championship points. You've got to be feeling good going into the pole position tonight.
For sure. I did a massive error there on lap two, so I thought I lost it, but I put everything I had after that, and I managed to, you know, to get back on Backrud there. So yeah, it was too tight. I think I felt I had it better under control, but a mistake is a mistake. So. No more of that today.
Kevin Ericsson, our top qualifier for today.
Thank you so much, Diana. Congratulations to Kevin Ericsson. Man, he is just exuding with emotion. I'm joking.
Typically hard on himself. That's quite an Ericsson trait. You know, dude, you just got the TQ, but he's like focused on that mistake. But I do like the fact that that's it. No more mistakes today.
Hey, regardless, he's the GoPro moment of the day. Look at this pass. Was it clean? Did you like it? I mean, he beat himself up, but again, it's like Travis. Oh, I can't work it all out, but it ends up working out in the end.
He used the classic Kevin Ericsson skill, which is backing it in big time. He comes in so hot and high into that banking. Had to make sure that he was alongside Backrud into the next left-hander. Andreas Backrud lifted off the throttle and tucked in to try and get back, but Kevin's got that covered. He's on the inside line. It was a great drive.
All right, well, some great racing there for Kevin Ericsson. Look at that, just that in car.
Yeah,
it's
so good.
Cool, man.
So good.
We're loving it. And you can see, you know, the dust, the dirt, the grime, all of it here. So, all right, well, we are going to take a short break. When we come back, Group E heats are upon us when we come back here at Nitro Cross.
Welcome to Sticker Mule.
Man, Sticker Mule kicks ass.
Try Sticker Mule. It's only a dollar.
Hello, I'm Rumble.
And I'm YouTube.
YouTube, why are you dressed like that?
Well, I've been seeing a lot of violations in the community lately, so I'm enforcing that.
You mean like people not following your policies?
Strike one!
What if someone tells the truth, but it's labeled as misinformation?
Strike two!
Wow, what if I want to ask questions and have different opinions on things?
Strike three! You're out of here!
This thing is a monster. The numbers do not lie.
The reality series did 15 million views, and that's in 12 weeks.
Slap has certainly been garnering attention all over the world, but social media is where it's taken off like a rocket ship.
We put on the highest quality productions.
The first ever live Power Slap event presented by Rumble.
Did the right promotion.
So many great storylines.
People learn their backgrounds and they're a fan of them as people.
So everything about this is going to go to the next level.
Power Slap.
This sport has only existed a few months. Imagine what we'll do over the next few years.
Sticker Mule is the fastest and easiest way to order custom stickers. It only takes a few seconds to order, and every purchase comes with a free online proof, free shipping, and blazing fast turnaround. Each sticker is made with a durable weatherproof vinyl that is suitable for indoor or outdoor use. Die-cut stickers are also available in familiar shapes, including circles, rectangles, squares, ovals, and rounded corner stickers. Try 10 custom stickers for $1 plus free shipping.
Hey, YouTube, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm updating my content policies.
Really? Do you mind if I take a look?
Sure. Yeah. Here you go. Oh, wait. One more.
This is a new one.
Thank you. I'll block off my schedule.
It's a real page turner. Oh, page 94 is my personal favorite.
Okay, can't wait. Honestly, YouTube, this is too much to read.
Welcome to Utah Motorsports Campus. This is the home of Nitrocross, the biggest jump in any four-wheel sport. I am Travis Pastrana. I'm going to take you through a lap here at Utah Motorsports Campus. Right as you take off, shifting through the gears in this FC1X 1,000 horsepower car, coming into a really long left. You have the option, usually on lap one, to take inside joker or outside. Really long left-hand corner. Now on the joker, it's going to tighten up really hard. Tightens up a bit here on the outside. Now getting straight is key. Have to hit this jump at about 100 kilometers an hour, and then wide open to 130 kilometers an hour over this big old jump. Pretty hard landing, hand breaking in the corner, backing it in. You want to be as high as you can get without hitting the wall. I've hit it twice so far this week. It's been pretty rough. And then also, the higher you get, the more banking this track has. Little Gymkhana style, up to 100-foot jump in the back stretch. It's been interesting. They've been underwatering, overwatering, so you always got to watch out your first lap coming through here. More banking on the outside, but this wall comes up really quick on the outside as well. Trying to cut it back for this long right-hand corner coming up to the crowd section. These FC1X cars have a lot of power and they have a lot of weight. One of the most difficult things is trying to keep these cars from sliding. Once they're sliding, you're losing time. But you have so much power to not slide them, it's almost impossible. What the heck, it's fun, right? So off camber on the inside, berm on the outside, coming over this final tabletop, trying to hit it as far to the right as possible, not nipping the left tire on that or the right tire on this as you come flying across the finish line, 140 miles an hour, and that is a lap on Utah Motorsports Campus Nitrocross.
It's a beautiful day, 30 seconds to race. Now this is Group E Heat 1. Here, let's talk about the racers, and then Coley will guide you in and what's at stake here. Frazier McConnell, Ollie Bennett, Benito Guerra, and Travis Pastrana. Remember, he didn't make it into that TQ round, but what's at stake here?
Yeah, so these guys are basically racing for their grid positions in the semifinals. Those drivers are in the top qualifier race. They get pole position in the semifinals, so they're in the best spot possible to go through and try and take pole for the main event later on today. And these guys will be trying to get the best possible slot they can to see if they can take the win. Frazier McConnell had a disastrous day yesterday, but he gets a pretty good start here. Pastrana's got a nice one on the outside as well. Bennett checks up early, goes to the joker. Guerra's gone with him. Pastrana trying to go around the outside of Frazier McConnell. Where is Travis Pastrana? He doesn't get there, has to tuck in behind. So it's McConnell and Pastrana heading up to the big gap jump, and Bennett and Guerra heading through the joker lap now.
Now keep in mind, the joker lap is the underneath. The big gap jump is the standard lap. So here we go. So out front, obviously, you could see that of, who's that?
Yes, out front is Frazier McConnell and Travis Pastrana.
So Pastrana,
yeah, Pastrana looks sideways, Jared, a little bit too hot on the way into the tarmac there. He took a low line on that big sweeping gravel bend. I thought he made up a little bit of time on Fraser McConnell there, but then just tucked it in a little bit too hard. I think this is the corner he had, is where he ended up in the wall earlier on. You can see it's pretty slick and a little bit more of a cautious approach in there.
What do you think's going through Fraser McConnell's head? As you said, he had a disastrous day, didn't make it to the finals. He wants redemption. You know, he had such a great Oklahoma weekend, but now, did you have any words with him and his team?
No, he's such a lovely guy. You can see he was championship leader when we came here with the big silver sun strip on the car, but that was taken away yesterday. Kevin Erickson leads now, and I think, yeah, the fact that Fraz didn't come and talk to us is a mark of how disappointed he was. You know what a great guy he is, lovely family, and he didn't want to talk yesterday, Jared. He was bitterly disappointed. You must make the finals. Every time you make the final, you can get a haul of points. Pastrana going up the inside on the brakes at the end of the straight. Fraser McConnell tucks back underneath him. They pass each other twice. McConnell into the side now. Pastrana holds onto the position, but that's two bits heavy contact. And I reckon Pastrana's car's damaged there because that's a very strange spin.
Yeah, that was odd. You know, what's really interesting here is I did have some words with Pastrana. He said he changed his tune a little bit to adapt and get better on the asphalt, because every time I got the asphalt, everybody took off from him, so he set up to get more traction on the asphalt. But I think maybe that compromise might have taken him out there. But Fraz really in on the inside, got aggressive. We're gonna have to run that back, but Fraz continues on and he leads it back.
It was a lovely pass from Pastrana late on the brakes, but that many got deep on the entrance to the corner, and Fraser's clever. You know, he's going, okay, you passed me on the brakes, but I know you're not gonna get to the apex. So he tucks it up underneath him, and then a little bit of contact. Unfortunately, Travis has come off worse. So 3.6 seconds is the gap between McConnell and Bennett. The Joker predictor down the bottom, it's not Travis in P2, it's Bennett who's in there, and we're saying Travis Pastrana retains fourth. Thanks for that, he definitely does.
Yeah, the Yokohama tire
it's
predictor never
on.
Lies.
It's bang
never
on.
Never lies. All right, so Fraz still out front, but it is yet to take that Joker lap. Here we are on lap 2 of 3. You know, you got to think Ollie Bennett, 3.6 seconds. He needs to gain more time on Fraz. And look at Benito. He finished fourth yesterday, and that was a really good showing. He had a big smile on his face, but look at Ollie Bennett.
His hood is
absolutely up and crinkled. That has seen better days.
That's going to be tough for him over the gap jump. Going to be hard to sight. He'll just have to hit the limiter and get cracking. Benito Guerra over the back of him now. Bennett goes up over the first tabletop. Now he's going to fly the gap with the hood up. Fair play, Ollie. He comes from a motorsport background. There, though, is Fraser McConnell coming from the joke lap, clearly into the lead. He had a gap of about three quarters out.
Look how tough that is. Oh, man.
He's having now just to spot the left-hand side. He's lost the position. Yeah. That's a shame for him. He's having to spot the left-hand side of the road. Now he backs off.
No sense in further damaging the vehicle or damaging, obviously, yourself, man.
Yeah.
That's a very unfortunate for Ollie Bennett. He was giving it a go, but Fraz and Travis seem to have the setup, but Fraser McConnell executes properly. And again, what's at stake here? All about grid position.
Yeah, so McConnell's going to be right up there. He's going to want to be as far up the grid as he can. It's a line, remember. You want to be close to the pole guy who's going to be on the inside line. Bennett's had to back completely. He cannot see, Jared. He's lost see the aero there? That sucks the air in and cools the motors down in the front, and unfortunately it's now. McConnell! Off the side of the road. Guerra goes through. Fraser
Holy
McConnell
cow.
Is that damaged from the contact with Pastrana? He goes round as well. Benito Guerra is going to nick this at the very end of the race. Ollie Bennett, I hope, doesn't come over that crest, not being able to see where he's going when Fraser McConnell is parked at the bottom of the tabletop. Now he's going again. The Jamaican's on the bar, flicks the car around, going to get it off down the straight. Oh, Bennett hits him. He couldn't see him. Exactly what we thought might happen. That is an absolute shocker for McConnell. He's parked at the side of the road. Bennett had nowhere to go and he couldn't see him. Wow.
What a crazy turn of events here. We're going to run it back. You know, from the contact from Fraser McConnell, Travis Pastrana, Fraz had the run, and then we saw Ollie Bennett, his hood flying up. Fraz pulls off. We need to find out what happened to Fraz there. That was a crazy turn of events.
Even if Bennett had been able to see where he was parked, he was on the downslope of the tabletop. You'd never know he was there, Jared. So even if Bennett could have seen, and of course he couldn't, Fraser just pinged the car around on the brake. He's livid.
Oh, the frustration just accumulates. You could see the face in the palms, or the helmet in the race gloves, man. Just wearing it like a bat suit. And check this out, Benito Guerra takes that position. You know, he ran a clean race. He didn't have the contact, didn't have the hood. He said, you guys fight it amongst yourselves. I'm gonna go ahead and win this thing. Here, Group E, Heat 1, Benito from Mexico gets the win.
Wow.
That was wacky.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, wacky between, again, Travis and Fraz get into it. Ollie's hood pops up, and then what the heck happened to Fraz? He had it. It was in the bag.
So Bennett goes off the brakes early, look, because Fraser's on that inside line. He knows he's not going to get there, and he tucks into the Joker. Comes out P3. We're all good at this point. It's at the end of the straight on the next lap, so they're coming through the pavement section onto lap two. So there's, look, there's the contact. Front right on front left. So McConnell ran a bit deep in the exit. Round goes Pastrana. I reckon maybe front transmission, Jared. It went round very quickly. Here it is from Bennett, who avoids him. Now look, Fraz is out front by a mile. Guerra gets up the inside of Bennett, who can't see anything. And then at the end of the lap, here's Fraz, look. What happens? Does he have contact with Guerra? No, he doesn't. Hooks a wheel on the inside.
Oh, he just dropped tire. He just dropped his tire, and then it pulled him in. So then Fraz, he just dropped tire. Just a simple little mistake. Benito Guerra comes out on top. And here we are for our group two. This is our group two, and this is all about, again, their heat position. So got Robin Larson, Connor Martell, Tanner Faust, welcome back. And Connor Daly, a great showing for him yesterday. Join us here in the booth is Robin Larson's teammate, DRR, JC, Monster Energy, RX Cartel, Andreas Backerud in the TQ. Haven't won a TQ, you said, ever.
Oh, get
man.
Loud.
Well, let's get loud here. Andrew Coley going to send it here for this.
Larson on the inside line gets away well, really well in fact, goes deep on the brakes. Martell tucks up from underneath him. Tanner Faust goes in. Connor Daly going to try for around the outside. He did well with this yesterday, but he's going to have to tuck in the end. So they're on the standard lap, Larson and Daly, and heading into the joke lap. Down below you've got Martell and Faust.
It looks very, very wet on the gravel.
Yeah, Travis was talking about that. They're actually wetting at the same amount as yesterday. They really want to minimize the dust, but there's cloud cover, so it's not drying out as much as it did yesterday. But still, would you rather have it wet? Oh, look at this. Would you rather have it really soaked, or would you have it dry?
That's the thing.
Yeah, just finding that. Yeah. You have that perfect window where it's absolutely ideal, right, Andreas?
Yeah, and that's super tricky. I mean, the track maintains, guys. Oh, we have an overtake here with Connor.
Tried very hard, then he couldn't quite get past Daly. He's definitely got more pace than him. Nudges into the rear bumper. Bit of steering lock over the curb on the inside line. He's all over the back of Daly. This is costing them big time. Ideal for your teammate, Robin Larson, driving away. Martell now does make the pass. Late on the brakes. Will Faust get through as well? Daly runs deep. He's out in the roost on the outside line. Two positions gone. Faust nudges a tyre stack on the inside. Nearly nudges Martell as they go over the tabletops. Great action.
These guys are getting aggressive, and this is just about grid position. I mean, what do you do here? I mean, yeah, you want the position, but you want to make it through. Maybe back off a little bit, or what's your strategy here?
I mean, Connor was in a very hard position. He hadn't done very much rallycross, and he said to me, I just want a clean lap one. But all of a sudden, the track is so wet, it's so different. So I think he just was surprised by the grip level being changed so much.
All right, so it looks like Robin Larson still out front. Connor Martell and Tanner Faust, the only two to take that Joker lap. Connor Martell had such a great day yesterday until the final.
The gap's only 1.9, Jared, and the delta's about 2.3, so Larson could be in trouble here. Remember, Martell yesterday was the TQ guy, didn't make it through to the top qualifier race earlier on today, but we know he's got that pace. I'd love to see a good result for Connor today after the disappointment of yesterday. It sucks to get a pole and then have a tech. Like, that's just not what you want.
Yeah, that was really disheartening. Connor absolutely gutted, just had an absolutely picturesque event yesterday. Okay, so here's the Yokohama Tire Joker predictor, and they are saying he's going to lose that number one position.
It's
as
very
you said,
tight,
Coley.
Though. It's very tight. It looks like Connor is losing a little bit to Robin. It feels like it's more 2 seconds than 1.9.
Look how aggressive Martell is with the car there. Tight in on the left-hand side, really flicked it back the other way. Gap was 1.9. When they come over the start-finish line, we'll have a better idea of whether or not Larson has edged out the 3 tenths he needs. This is the last lap, so watch out now. But ducking off to the inside line. Here goes Larson. The gap is 1.4. So Martell's closed in by 0.5 of a second. Now he's just got to keep it really tidy for the merge.
Yeah, this is all about this positioning right now. And it looks like Connor Martell, you can see him going for the big gap jump. Robin Larson, you can see him in that tabletop Joker lap. And Connor Martell is going to assume the lead over Rob. Look at him maxing out that angle.
Yeah, that was fantastic.
That was
he came
well
in
done.
With a lot of speed there. I actually thought he'd be further ahead of Larson than that, but he wasn't. Robin Firmino, bounced a little bit on the bar, coming up around through that left-hander. That's slick, isn't it? I reckon that's where the wet dirt's going out onto the pavement. But Robin, you'll have seen it, I'm sure, Andreas, he turned in twice into the right-hander just before the tabletop, I guess trying to feel what the grip levels were like. And
yeah.
I don't know if it would have been enough. If
For
it,
sure,
if
we will
perfect.
See Robin trying to go on a pass there now.
Oh, he's
Look
smoking
at the different strategies
up.
Here. Robin Larson smoking him out.
He took the high line. He's going to try on the inside now.
Martel's nailed it on. Look, Larson will flick it in as well.
It's
he's
hard to
right there. And now Martel's just got to avoid hooking it in too tight and pulling the car around. But Conor Martel going to take the tabletop up. Butters the landing. Nothing Larson can do about that from there. So Martel runs all the way across the road. They've removed those concrete barriers. It's high speed over the start finish line. A win for Martel from Robin Larson. Very close, though.
Yeah, well done by Conor Martel. Getting his gusto back. Look at that. The hammer, the rebel yell. Conor Martel gets it done. Robin Larson there in second. He says, come on, let's leave.
Look at the difference here when we saw Fraser McConnell thrashing the wheel a minute ago because he was so disappointed. Yeah. Now we're seeing him thrashing the wheel because he's so stoked.
Yep.
Whoever sells the wheels is probably like, keep going, guys. Like, you know, keep smashing those bad boys up. Yeah. Fraser McConnell's car just coming back past the announcing booth now.
Same damage as Travis.
Yeah.
Rear left. Wheel, just not the puncture on left front.
And there it is. Conor Martel gets the win. You can see Larson, Faust, and Daly. It's all about positioning for their heats. Here are some highlights as we take a look back. A decent start here, but Conor Martel had something to prove.
See, it looked like Faust almost backed off the line there, Jared, like he was going to tuck straight in behind, you know, from out further on the grid, thought he'd maybe get in. This was Conor Daly. Martel just looked really racy on that first lap, and you lose one position, you can lose them all.
To be honest, big up to Conor, because he was really fast there. Even losing a bit of time that first lap behind Conor Daly.
I loved how aggressive he was on that loose section when we saw the onboard really flicking the car around. We know he's hot on the dirt, but there's that lovely big gap jump. Tanner Faust back as well. Great to have
look at
the right.
Descend for...
here we go.
Oh, wow. It's like Kevin around the outside Ericsson does, you know? It's all about the commitment.
All right, well done to Conor Martel. We're going to have some words with Benito in just a moment.
Welcome to Sticker Mule.
Man, Sticker Mule kicks ass.
Try Sticker Mule. It's only a dollar.
Hello, I'm Rumble.
And I'm YouTube.
YouTube, why are you dressed like that?
Well, I've been seeing a lot of violations in the community lately, so I'm enforcing that.
You mean like people not following your policies?
Strike one!
What if someone tells the truth, but it's labeled as misinformation?
Strike two!
Wow, what if I want to ask questions and have different opinions on things?
Strike three! You're out of here!
This thing is a monster. The numbers do not lie.
The reality series did 15 million views, and that's in 12 weeks.
PowerSlap has certainly been garnering attention all over the world, but social media is where it's taken off like a rocket ship.
We put on the highest quality productions.
The first ever live PowerSlap event presented by Rumble.
Did the right promotion.
So many great storylines.
People learn their backgrounds, and they're a fan of them as people.
So everything about this is going to go to the next level.
PowerSlap.
This sport has only existed a few months. Imagine what we'll do over the next few years.
Sticker Mule is the fastest and easiest way to order custom stickers. It only takes a few seconds to order, and every purchase comes with a free online proof, free shipping, and blazing fast turnaround. Each sticker is made with a durable weatherproof vinyl that is suitable for indoor or outdoor use. Die-cut stickers are also available in familiar shapes, including circles, rectangles, squares, ovals, and rounded corner stickers. try 10 custom stickers for $1 plus free shipping.
Hey, YouTube, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm updating my content policies.
Really? Do you mind if I take a look?
Sure. Yeah. Here you go. Oh, wait. One more.
This is a new one.
Thank you. I'll block off my schedule.
It's a real page turner. Oh, page 94 is my personal favorite.
Okay. Can't wait. Honestly, YouTube, this is too much to read.
Well, it's great to have some winners here on the couch, you know, here in the family room. And so many different forms of racing going on here this weekend, you know, from obviously Group E, side-by-side. You got Next. You even have the Baja Buggies. And everybody's favorite, the Van Prix. But we have a special guest racing here this weekend. Do you like Van Prix? Do you like minivans? You ever seen minivans race? Well, guess what? We got a special guest joining us here in Utah. Let's take a look.
It's time for you to meet the Next Motor Sporting legend, talented, fast, elite. None of these words apply to Andrew Coley, competing in motorsports' toughest challenge tonight. Are you ready? Because he is not.
I don't know what to think, Coley. What do you think, man? How's your van look? How's your race car look?
I went testing this morning around the paddock. It's Tanner Fowles called it a piece of something, and he's right. It's terrible. Well, it doesn't change from first to second gear, so the rev limit's 3,200, which means I get a top speed of 31 miles an hour at the minute. So I did notice if I lift and then really gently go on the gas, it might take second gear. So I'm really glad I'm not doing the gap jump. That's like my main thoughts on it. I'm still terrified.
I think the van knows exactly who's behind the wheel, so they tempered the flame because they knew you were driving.
Yeah, man. You gotta take care, you know? You don't get too nuts.
Well, you know what? Hey, super excited about, again, our family room right here. We got fans coming up talking to some drivers here. You know, most notably, let's take a look at Group E Heat 1 here. And taking a look here.
Frazier, talk us through it, man.
Man, I don't know. I had contact with Travis and I knew the front right was bent. And then, you know, we came back in and then the left rear is fully bent. And I'm not going to hide it, guys. I'm really pissed off. I don't know what's wrong this weekend, but, you know, something's not going my way and I'm about to blow.
Yeah, well, we appreciate you being here. And I know Diana wanted to have some words with you. We didn't see you yesterday at all, but that is racing, man, and you had such a good Oklahoma, right? And then coming here, you know, it's tough, man. And I appreciate you being honest.
Everything happens for a reason, but, you know, I know I have the pace. I've been, you know, so fast all weekend, and every race has just not gone my way. You know, the race that I do win, I got disqualified, you know, 3 millimeters too low below the minimum.
Well,
you know, good thing that happens.
Yeah, all right. She's bringing some Jamaican voodoo this way.
Was that Fraser's mom?
I think that was Fraser's mom. So look at that. He's smiling now. He's got some good big ups energy right there.
I have the support from Jamaica and my family is here. So, you know, I want to put on a show for everyone here. The Team Fraz fans from local and abroad are really showing out this weekend. But
You can turn it around, dude. I know you feel bad.
This is Nitrocross. Stuff happens, you know. Andreas is your human
support animal.
Yeah, look at me yesterday. I mean, it just happens just like that.
No, dude.
We're terrible. Not supposed to be nice to each other. You're supposed to race each other. You're supposed to beat each other.
The hammer sees that the spike is down. Sometimes you need to turn it the other way around and lift it up, you know.
Take a look at the highlights here. Heat 2, guys. We're going to have a look at this one as well. Connor, you're in the mix here, and you were right up behind Connor Daly. Lovely pass, mate. You looked like you had pace. He was struggling a little bit on the slippery stuff, and then you and Tanner both got through.
Yeah, it was a little wet up top there, and he just kind of overcooked the turn, and I could see he didn't have any drive out, so I kind of stuck it in there, and luckily I had some good grip coming out.
Yeah, and again, this was just such a big moment for you, all about redemption, right? And we saw in your cockpit, you're yelling at the top of your lungs. I got to bring in Benito
look,
here.
Look now.
Look at this.
Woo-hoo. Yeah,
master,
man.
That was sick.
I really needed to beat Larson. He had a few choice words for me last night after the final. So, in
your head, did you believe you were Kevin Erickson there for a moment?
I tried to be for a second, and it worked.
Hey, Benito, congratulations. Your first win, man. That was awesome. Fourth place last night. You're feeling good today?
Yeah, I'm feeling way more confident than in Oklahoma.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get these guys' times. It's not easy.
Yeah.
Coming from a mental disaster in Oklahoma. But now I think we are doing things great. It was a victory, my first victory in a heat in Nitro Cross, and I'm really happy to be in the front row for the semifinals.
That's what's up. There you go. Andreas, obviously, congratulations. Second place in TQ. More Nitro Cross when we return here in the family room. You can hear the bikes going off, two wheels, four wheels, all the wheels, and even minivans with my man, Andrew Coley. Don't go anywhere.
Yokohama Tire. Make every drive a performance. My Energy. Driving the charge to a sustainable future. Rumble. Bold and free. GoPro, official camera of the Nitro Cross.
Green light, let it go.
Coley, if I had to put my money on it, buddy, I think I could take you in my new little contraption here. But guys, next up is our semifinals, Group E. Take it away.
What a beautiful backdrop and what a beautiful track. 1.4 miles, and here's our road to the final. Coley, what is at stake? How is this going to break down?
Three semifinals coming up. The winner of each of those semifinals will go straight through, as you can see, to row one, either inside or outside, or potentially the inside of row two. And that basically goes back to their qualifying positions earlier on. So the top qualifier was Kevin Erickson. If he wins the last semi-final, he will be on pole in the final. The rest of the final is made up from the last chance qualifiers. So you get two drivers from LCQ1 and three drivers from LCQ2.
There you go. There you have it. Here we go. Group E semi-final one. You're seeing Oliver Erickson, Tanner Faust, and Ollie Bennett. Probably Ollie Erickson, the favorite here to come out on top. Tanner Faust having a good time, just really trying to figure out the car, get it down. Ollie Bennett, a lot of racecraft, just needs to put it all together.
Yeah, I mean, Faust, you know, he's new to this car, Jared, and you can't jump in any car that everybody else has been in for a couple of years, especially not when you're up against the likes of Ollie Erickson, who, as we know, is from the family that builds these cars. He's been having a great weekend, so Erickson on the inside line. Faust has got a good start. And he dives on the brakes. So Faust goes straight in. And wow. Bennett has pushed Ollie Erickson in there. Ollie Erickson had to cross the inside line. Two wheels, the FC1X, luckily doesn't go over. But did Bennett give him enough room or not? Meanwhile, Faust, you can see at the bottom of your picture, is heading into the Joker lap.
Yeah, that could have been absolutely disastrous for Ollie Bennett. Tanner Faust, like you said, going for the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. Now they merge, and the zipper comes and happens. Both the Excite vehicles. It looks like Ollie Bennett comes out on top. And the number 34, Tanner Faust in second. Ollie Erickson bringing up the rear.
So they cost themselves time in turn one, Jared. Remember the final yesterday when Travis Pastrana was so surprised to be in the lead. You don't take the Joker lap, which is 2.3 seconds longer, and expect to come out in the lead. And Faust has basically come out in P2 behind Bennett. Now, if I were Excite, I'd Joker Bennett on the next lap. They could use Faust to back up Erickson behind, but I think they'll be looking to get Tanner a good result.
All right. Ollie Bennett getting that clean air. Is Tanner Faust going to run a block here over Ollie Erickson? You can see the hood flap. Give him a little Busta Rhymes rap there. And oh, look at, so there it is. That's kind of what the Erickson medicine. And Ollie goes into the wall there. And Ollie Bennett is out front, but Ollie Erickson having some trouble in that third place position.
So I wonder if Erickson will have any damage to that. Jared, as well, you'll notice they've removed all the concrete blocks onto the straight, which just means it's that bit quicker. They send Bennett. That's the right thing to do. Send Tanner Faust. Faust gets a bail on the inside. There's hay all over the road as Ollie Erickson comes through. Remember, Tanner Faust has jokered already. Ollie Erickson hasn't. So if Faust wins this, he'll go straight through to one of the top three positions in the final, and that's great for the Excite team.
You know, yesterday he did not make the final. You know, but neither of the Excite vehicles made it, right? Ollie Bennett and Tanner Faust, they both sat out.
Okay.
And, that was out. Oh no, excuse me, Fraser McConnell there. But as hay bales all over the course right now.
Front left off Ollie Erickson's car. He's got no front left tire, and still he goes up the inside of Ollie Bennett.
Charges into the door.
Have a look at the front left. I'm sure it was off the rim just a second ago. Yeah, it is.
But man, Ollie Bennett not backing down. Absolutely. Tire Schmeier, we don't need it. We're going to set this place on fire. Tanner Faust still out front, and that could give Tanner Faust a clear and present advantage.
Look in the background. You can see how much he's struggling through the left-handers, Jared, because the Yokohama tire's off the rim. Because he hit the wall. Nothing wrong with that tire. He hit the wall hard and knocked it off. If he can keep Bennett behind, it's good job. But I'm wondering now whether or not he's going to be up for doing gap jumps or not. I mean, Ken Block did it with only three tires.
Yep, and Ollie Erickson, man, I mean, he's collecting them all. He went up on two wheels. His hood's banged up. He has no tire on the front left corner, the back right corner. And here's Tanner Faust coming out unscathed. You know, it was Ollie Bennett and him that got into it, and Tanner Faust took that joker lap out of the gate, and it seems to have paid off.
Faust looking so clinical as well, Jared. Late on the brakes, but smooth. No locked wheels. One input on the steering. Like, he's looking really good. It's nothing less than we'd expect from him. Up and over the gap jump. Flies it beautifully. Look.
Yeah.
Great to have him back. Great to have him back. One of the greatest rallycross drivers in the world. This is Nitrocross, of course, but he has won in every other level. He's won GRC, ARX, World Rallycross, European Rallycross, and here he is now. He wants to take a Nitrocross win. That would arguably make him a driver who's won in every category. I don't think there'd be any others.
No, he's won. You know, he's competing now in Extreme E as well. So he's definitely a busy man. He is behind the wheel of so many cars and films as well. So it's really great to see Tanner Faust join us. You know, two-time Formula Drift champion. Formula Drift slide in here just about a few weeks. So excited to see Tanner Faust in the mix. It looks like he is going to come out unscathed, and he's going to come out finding his way into the final, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, super tidy from the number 34. Sends the car around the right-hander. He's going to pop up over that tabletop now. Tanner Faust on his debut weekend in Nitrocross yesterday. Didn't make the final today. Skips the next couple of sessions. And the number 34 will be in P1, 2, or 3 later on today. In the background, that is it Bennett? It is, yeah, Bennett. And then Erickson coming sliding through with the puncture.
And the hood flap and all of it.
Yeah.
Like I said, he collected them all. Love to have Tanner Faust in here. You know, Yokohama supporting him, Optima Battery. So let's get some words with Tanner Faust, get him here in the family room, talk to him about, you know, his Nitrocross experience as well as everything he's got cooking. Let's take a look at it here again. Ollie Bennett and Ollie Erickson getting into it right out of the gates. And like you said, did Bennett give Erickson enough room, or was Erickson a little too aggressive? But it is official. Tanner Faust gets the victory. He finds himself into the finals. Ollie Bennett sitting in second. Ollie Erickson sitting in third.
And that contact is under investigation, Jared. I suppose they could flip it round. To be honest, though, it doesn't make a difference to where they line up on the grid in the LCQ. But this is all about Tanner Faust.
What do you see?
Here it is, yeah. I mean, Bennett, yeah. If that had been a wall and not a hay bale, Ollie Erickson's got nowhere to go. So I suspect they're going to say, look, Lee drives into me. Yeah, I love Ollie, but I think on this occasion...
Yeah, I mean, which Ollie do you like? They're both Ollies.
They're both Ollies, that's true.
I love Ollie. It's very generic of you.
Yeah, it was good, wasn't it? I bailed there completely accidentally. I was totally non-committed.
You hay bailed or did you bail there? Because they hit the hay bales.
Oh, wow. Oh, all boy. The puns.
I mean, you're not even a dad.
Fire.
Dad jokes
we're
for days.
We're on fire. Here's a move. Ollie having a look up the inside of Ollie. Erickson having a look up the inside of Ollie Bennett. Side by side over the tabletop jump. He gets inside him here. Look, off the dirt, onto the pavement, back onto the dirt. There's that big gap jump. A brilliant drive by Tanner Faust. He is going to go straight to the final. Can he complete his collection of wins across all the various series? You couldn't bet against him.
Ollie. What happened out there? Walk us through it.
Yeah, turn one. Ollie Bennett, I don't know what he does. He almost flipped me into turn one. I'm so pissed right now. If that's not a penalty, I don't know what is. So.
Have you had words with Bennett yet?
No, I was about to, but everyone stopped me, so maybe I was lucky for him.
Okay, we will see him in the LCQ, guys.
Enter the reigning Nitrocross champion, the Iceman Robin Larson. Rarely missing the podium, the Swede got three event wins on his way to becoming the 2022-2023 champion. And he never once dropped the championship lead. Talk about consistency. He did all this despite severely injuring his neck in a workshop accident at the start of the season. His driving style has matured into efficient precision, but when the wind calls for it, nobody is safe from his big sends.
Larson dives in on the inside, looks, he fends him off. He's going for a block pass. Robin Larson with a block pass over Strada.
Usually a stoic Iceman, his burning desire to win can sometimes make him crack.
Hello.
Brimming with confidence and skill, can anyone dethrone Larson this season? Well, one thing's for sure, the Iceman won't surrender easily.
All right, here we go. Next with our Group E semifinal two, Andreas Backlund, Robin Larson, the DRR JC vehicles. Benito Guerra, he won his heat earlier. Can he do it again? And Fraser McConnell, a bit of bad luck. He's not feeling the flow right now. He says, feeling the flow, feeling the vibe, come on now. It's cool running time.
That's good, Chad. Great stuff. I wonder what the tactics will be for the cartel on the inside, because they're both going to want to go standard lap if they can. You know, there's no guarantee if you take the Joker on the first lap, you're not going to get caught in traffic. So it might be a case of who wins the start takes it. Backwood on the inside line is obviously in the best position to do so. Very even start. I reckon Larson's backing off already. Is he going to dive in the race? He doesn't. So Backwood goes Joker. That must have been pre-decided. That's the inside camera. Lovely on the Armco. Runs up though over the curb on the inside line. But there's no damage on that.
I reckon that's
pre-decided tactics.
Corley joined us in the booth. He's our most recent winner. As he's going to the finals. He can be cool, calm, and collected. Mr. Tanner Faust is in the building. Tanner, congratulations. Andrew Corley picked you up about all your accolades in Rallycross. Coming into the Group E, little experience, but now you put it together here in day two of our doubleheader weekend.
Yeah, I mean, this is the tricky track to learn to, I mean, drive a car for the first time at. That's for sure. You can see there's a lot going on, and just riding side by side, the racing is absolutely epic. It's nice to see some passing going on.
Yeah.
Difficult to pass. The cars are spectacular. The landings are incredible, but everybody is really on about the same pace. So the passing can be really tricky.
Travis was really happy on day one. He's like, this track races well on two separate lines. I think we've all seen good passing in the back corners. The new clay cap surface has definitely been better from a tyre situation. We saw Fraser McConnell get past Guerra there. Benito was just a little bit sideways on that back section of pavement. And McConnell was livid earlier, Jared, wasn't he?
Yeah. What's your favorite portion of the track? I mean, between the tabletop jumps, do you agree with that tabletop in front of the gap jump to kind of set the pace and set the cadence? Also, what's your favorite part of the track?
I like it. I like the tabletop. Oh, that is impressive right there. Gets spread out there and you come in the next lap.
Yeah. You did, didn't you? And it was all over the road.
I grenaded the thing. It was in the middle of the road and there was no way inside, outside. They warned you that if you went inside of them, it's trouble. But I really like this section. I mean, I'm familiar with the gap jump racing here once before, but the tabletop beforehand sets it up. As long as it's not wet. If it's wet, then you may not have the speed to make the full gap.
So you were here in the Beetle one. Was that 2018, the very first one, I think?
Yeah. Here in the Beetle. Never did well. I think I got on the podium one time, though, but never won it.
And the first part of the track is really similar, isn't it? Right up to the right-hander after the gap jump. And since then, the back part of the track has been developed. And I love the flow of it. I think it's cool.
It is a great flow. That tabletop back there, to put it in perspective, I think the tabletop on the back half of the track is bigger than any jump we ever had at Jersey.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I genuinely think so. Yeah. It is a massive lip. You're so far in the air, if you land it flat, it's like 30 feet too flat. It's incredible.
I'll bear that in mind for the van later on, although I'm not sure it comes out of first gear. So 31 mile an hour, don't know how much air I'm going to get. We'll see.
Coley's going to be tearing up this track a little bit earlier. And Coley, he is hitting in the Dodge Caravan. It's going to be amazing. Hold your caravan. All right, Robin Larson is leading it right now. Coley, what's his scenario?
He's only got 1.2. That should be enough for Backwood. So Backwood, McConnell as well. He's only 1.7. So Larson now coming underneath in the Joker lap. Doesn't look good, does it, the car?
No, there's tons of water on that Joker lap, and he caught it out for the first time. He didn't watch maybe those previous heats. I got a little crossed up there also, and that cost him some time.
He might get underneath McConnell. McConnell just into the back bumper. That's really nicely done by Larson. Yeah, by all accounts, he only had 1.7. He still managed to hold on, really, 0.5 like that. And Fraser should have got that, but came in really low, got the rotation done. But this looks like Backwood's going to be booking his spot in the final with Mr. Bowse.
And you can just feel the frustration of Fraser McConnell right now. Again, when he was in here earlier, Mom kind of cheered him up a little bit. But, you know, the DRRJC vehicles, I mean, Larson and Martell exchanged words. I mean, all of the, we start the weekend like, hey, how's it going? Cool. Now it's like, and then like, you son of a beep.
These three guys were the top three in the championship last year. Remember, Fraz was in P3. He's come into this season thinking, I want to be the champion. He's won the first event, Jared. He's like, this is my championship year, and it's gone out the window here in Utah. So I understand the frustration, but he's got another chance. Still got the LCQ to go. Meanwhile, Andreas Backer is going to come down, take the checkered flag. He wins semi-final two from his teammate Larson, and he goes straight through to the final.
There you go. Backer gets the win. Larson, DRRJC. Benito Guerra comes up in fourth, so Backer will be joining our man Tanner Faust here in the booth.
That's no fun. Backer races hard.
Yeah, he's, oh, for you. Yeah. You're looking at yourself. Well, guess what? Andreas Backerud gets the win. Robin Larson, Fraser McConnell, Benito Guerra, and Tanner Faust saying, that's no fun, because Andreas Backerud's one tough cookie, and he loves cookies.
He does.
Yeah, he does.
He's actually coming to my house this week.
Is he?
Today.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, he's like on a road trip across America.
But if he beats you, is he still invited?
I don't think so.
Bear that in mind, Andreas.
All right, let's see. Coley, walk us through some of these moments.
Yeah, Benito Guerra at the back here. So watch, he gets just a little bit too sideways here on the dirt. We don't see it, but Fraser McConnell gets up the inside. And then Larson, you know, did okay to hold on to the position P2. I thought he did really well getting inside it. Look how low he is. Kind of almost a block pass on Fraser McConnell. Really nice to done because, as I say, with a gap of 1.7, look, slots in there like a parking gap. It was tiny, wasn't it?
That was a hip check. It is very, very narrow. You can see he was committed full sideways a good 40 feet before in the concrete wall.
All right, well, here we are with our final Group E semifinal three. You got the number 199, Travis Pastrana, Connor Daly. Come from the open wheel world, but he had a good showing last night. He said he was on pace with the big boys. And then Connor Martell and, of course, Kevin Erickson. Speaks softly, carries a big angle, and he is ready to go outside and drop in on his fellow competitors. Who's going to come out on top again? Number one goes into the finals, joining Tanner Faust and Andreas Backerud. Backerud joined us here in the booth. We'll have some words with him as soon as Coley sends it.
Here we go then, down towards turn one. Great start by Connor Martell, outside Kevin Erickson. Erickson's gonna go into the joke up. Daly goes with him. So it's Martell and Pastrana, the teammates on the outside line. So Pastrana's not gonna nudge into him in turn two. Tightly done by them. Vermont Sports Car on the same strategy, which is on the standard lap first. Kevin Erickson leads on the joker.
There we go. So Kevin Erickson, he's just going to start twisting the screws there in that kicker vehicle.
Jared, we're hearing as well that we think, looking at the data, that the delta has come down potentially to 1.5, which is how Larson got out in front of McConnell last time round. So Erickson, look, he's right there on the back now. You could argue that you could use Pastrana to check him up and put, oh my goodness, Martell went long there, didn't he?
Travis, I think it was Travis. Yeah.
Yeah, that was Travis there.
I was looking out the front window. I was looking at Martell.
Oh, look how wet it is there now.
Oh, okay. Oh. So a lot of wet down on the track, slippery grip conditions. So is Pastrana going to back Erickson up? No, Eric. Yeah, I wonder if he is. What do you think?
I mean, it's hard to judge. Travis is racing for himself. He want to win this race. He won yesterday. He want to take a double. I don't think Travis would ever back anyone down.
Oh, no. Look at that. Running
went wide.
Deep. Yeah, but then gets a nice exit as well. But now Pastrana even closer to him. So
this session here was really slippery when I was driving.
Look how sideways Erickson is coming onto the straight in the back as well. Dust for Daly, can't really see. So Pastrana now dives on the brakes early. He's going to go to the joke back again. 0.7 back to Erickson. It was only 0.5. So Travis should lose out here to Erickson once Erickson gets over the gap jump.
Yeah, I didn't understand the joker tactic there. Because if I was Vermont, I would keep Travis out there and try to gap Erickson to the last lap.
There comes Erickson to Erickson, who's already joking. He's in front of Travis, so that's going to mean that Travis is not going to be able to go through from this one.
But hey, I'm no expert.
No, of course. I think you probably are, Andreas.
You're the most educated,
the world champion when you're standing here with you
Mate,
guys.
Tell me about it.
Yeah. So Connor Martell out front there. You can see the time slip there, 1.379.
Look here now in the exit. There's aquaplaning here on the tarmac. Super,
a lot of water.
Super tricky to drive there now.
Yeah, a lot of wheel spin you're going to get on that, aren't you? As you transition across. The gap is only 1.3, but the delta is only 1.5 potential. So this could be
really here is the Yokohama Tire Joker predictor, and boom, he's going to lose that first position. And you got to keep in mind it's Kevin Erickson.
He went wide there as well.
Hey, also, I got to ask you, you know, they are running on the slicks. What do you think of the new Yokohama Tire?
It's better than ever. They've done a great job developing the tire, much better on the dirt and also on the tarmac. So. Yeah, good.
Let's check this gap now as they come over the start finish line. It was 1.3 and it is now 1.3, so he's still holding on. So Martell, despite the first couple of corners, it's nice on the inside line there as he goes joker. Kevin Erickson around the outside line. 1.3 versus Tadeo, 1.5. This is going to be super close.
He's got to be really tidy here. Connor Martell has to make no mistakes. Goes over that tabletop. Well done by Connor Martell. It's going to be close. Here comes Kevin Erickson, who's getting the fast pass. And there it is. Connor Martell slides on in. Kevin Erickson, who's known for going outside. He goes on the inside, but he still gets it. Kevin Erickson gets the pass on Connor Martell. He straightens it out. Now he's going to get wide, throw out his elbows.
The front row of the LPQ where three guys sports go car. Through.
Had such a good day yesterday. Had those mechanicals in the final, and it just all went for not. So unfortunately, it looks like Kevin Erickson will be getting the win.
I say unfortunate for Connor Montana, but yeah, Kevin Erickson is excited. I mean, this is a great trio. Andreas, kudos to you. Again, Tanner Faust in the mix. He has so many accolades in the rallycross world. So he says, oh, it's going to be a tough one. And now, here's your trio, you, man. Tanner, and Kevin.
Yeah, man, I must say, give it to Kevin, because many times I'm like, we have tough fights, but today I told him you're bang on the money.
So yesterday, Connor Martell was the top qualifier and went through to pole in the final. Today, it's Kevin Erickson who took his first ever top qualifier spot and will now go through to take pole in the final for Erickson. Martell with the pace right behind, but not quite able to get the job done. Taylor coming over Pete Drew and Pastrana dropping back to fourth.
Yeah, dropped back quite a bit there. So, and seeing some words from Kevin Erickson, looks like he, I mean, his demeanor looks like he lost the race. You know, he doesn't like,
yeah, like he didn't cross about a mistake he made. Yeah,
exactly.
One apex that he missed.
But again, we always talk about how he's so good on going outside. And he dropped in after that jump.
It was a great move.
Came out on the inside. Absolutely top-notch move. Kevin Erickson, like you said, he gets the TQ belt. He gets the win. So that means he gets pole in the finals. Congrats to Kevin Erickson, Martell, Daly, and Pastrana. They need to fight for the right to party in the finals.
I must say, he didn't have faster lap time than me, so.
Hey, boom goes the dynamite.
Andreas is already lining up what's going to happen in the final. So will it be you and Kevin on the front row? Yes, it will. So Andreas backward and Kevin Erickson on the front row.
And I'm going to beat Andreas around the outside backward.
Yeah, okay, so you're going to
it's me and you, baby.
Look at that. That is unbelievable, isn't it? I think that was on board with the drone underneath the gap jump. Fantastic. This is the move that slides in the tiniest bit of contact. There's a little bit of blue groove coming up in that dirt bank bend as well.
It's a bit naughty as well.
Well, yeah, come on.
We're
not stewards, are we, Andreas? No. If you did it, would it be naughty?
No.
Yeah, there we go.
You know, he hit his front wheel, so what could Connor do?
Right, so come on. See, if he did that to you, it's not on, but if you did it to him, it's okay.
Yeah.
There we go. You see, that's drivers for you. They always think they're right.
All right, so, yeah, he talks out of both sides of his mouth.
Well, that's a terrible move. I'd love it if I did.
Once he puts the shades on, he's a different Andreas.
I'm fast.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Again, this is the family. We have our great friends, Danielle and Brandon Steinecker, drummer for Rancid, and just absolute talent. Great friends of Ken Block, hence the KB Forever. And got matching tattoos with you, right?
Oh, yeah. Here we go. Yeah. Here we go.
There's the 43. You got the 43. I don't know. Where is it out in your body? There it is right there.
There it is.
Love it. All right. Well, again, stick
You're
around. Don't go
too.
Anywhere. Hey, I got mine. That's back here. All right. Throw it down to Diana Algren. What do you got, Diana?
You guys, it's Ollie versus Ollie here with Oliver Bennett. Please tell us your side of the story. What happened out on that track just now?
I mean, we're sort of coming down the start straight. As you guys know, it's super fast down this straight. I'm actually on my boost, so I'm giving it everything for turn one, and I'm just looking at the apex. As far as I can see from my left, I was clear P1 into that corner, so I just went around the corner. Didn't know, obviously looking back at the cameras, Ollie's there on the inside. I think he maybe should have braked out of it, but he's come in with me and hit the bail, so that's caused him to lose some time there. But yeah, I think I was in the right position in racing incident, if anything, but yeah, I was flat out and I took turn one, so.
Have you had a word with Erickson yet?
No, I haven't. No, I'm sure I'll see him in the paddock somewhere. The Ericssons do get a bit frustrated sometimes with these things, but yeah, I'm pretty cool with it. I mean, yeah, racing incidents happen. I was going for the turn one, so.
Thank you very much, Ollie. Guys, take it away.
Thank you so much, Diana. And he, like you said, he calls it like he sees him. You know, Erickson's get a little heated. And you know what? It creates, hey, like I said, stirs the pot.
I just love seeing the explanation, too. I was just looking at the apex down to turn one. I didn't know he was there. It's like, good for you, Ollie, because that's, I love it. It's drivers.
Yeah. Yeah. I just love it's not me.
Yeah, exactly. It's never you, is it? It's
well, you talk about going for the apex. I'm wondering how fast you're going to go to the apex, because
31 miles an hour based on the
gearbox
earlier.
You're making your Nitro Cross debut. He's very talented. No, he's not. He's very outspoken. Of course he is. But you know what? Why not get some lessons from one of the best?
I needed tips.
Yeah, you needed some tips. But
he's wanted everything except Nitrocross, so I thought I'd go and ask him.
Well, you might not be first, but you might be Faust. Tanner Faust. He gave you some tips for the Van Prix. Let's take a look.
So I'm down the paddock with this man, the legendary Tanner Faust, the number 34. Welcome back to Nitrocross.
Thank you very much. Super excited.
You should be. He's racing a 1,000 horsepower Group E car. Yeah, we got side-by-sides, we got Baja Bugs, we've got NRX next, but I'm making my debut this weekend, and I get to race this. What do you think?
I mean, besides the paint job, what a piece of
crap. Okay.
Your professional racing debut in this.
Yeah, my American racing debut, you know? So I mean, but I need some tips.
Let's take a closer look, maybe.
Okay. So Tanner, it looks, I'm trying to look on the bright side, it's beautifully prepared, isn't it?
Wow. I mean, you do not want a forensic scientist coming into this thing. That is for sure. There's pools of something all over the place.
It's, I mean, we're trying to make it lightweight. It's got nice, I mean, there's seats, if I could take some passengers.
You gotta lose those, yeah.
Do you think it's got anti-lag?
No.
1,000 horsepower?
No airbag. I mean, you got your wires hanging out where the airbag was.
I'm pretty pleased about that. We've seen airbags go through the windscreen, down the side. I mean, yeah.
Like, you know you're doing something right when it's safer to get rid of the safety equipment.
Yeah.
This thing, I mean, they have power. I think they're over 240 horsepower.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Front or rear wheel drive?
Front wheel drive.
Okay.
You got decent tread on the tires.
Sick.
Yeah, and basically on the jumps, I think the bigger you hit them, the smoother the landing.
Okay.
Yeah, because you want to clear the tabletop. The problem is if you don't clear the tabletop and you double bounce, then you make it two jumps instead of just one.
So I want to hit the down ramps. Okay, so hit the jumps at speed. Okay.
Yes, at speed.
A few more driving tips. So we've already gone over the incredible spec and preparation on these machines. Any tips in terms of going for the win?
I don't have a tip, but I do feel something. And rarely in racing do you really get synergy between a driver and a vehicle. And I can tell you and this van are perfectly matched.
I can't wait. I mean, it's ready for the big jumps.
I don't ever want to see that image again. That's okay. Looks like you're humping a giant banana.
Public Square, America's marketplace. Download the app today. O'Reilly Auto Parts, professional parts people.
My name is Cowboy Cerrone. I, at one point, was one of the top UFC lightweight fighters. Same hours, same energy I put into wanting to be the baddest UFC fighter there was. Same thing I'm gonna try and do with dirt racing and rally racing.
So we're gonna do a braking drill. It's such a fundamental skill that we teach. I like to knock it out right in the morning so we have it moving to any of the courses.
Braking early, easing off the brake and being able to touch that cone and hit the right apex to stay in the speed that I need. At first, I was all over the place and my man tightened me up and made me look right.
Brake, right to that inside. See how swept off it is in there already?
Now we are learning the ins and outs of how to perfect the apexes of the corners, how to be fast where I can and be slow where I need to be. Go out there and compete with the guys that have been doing this for a long time and try and really make some waves.
Really, a lot of times it's that little moment of patience that does all the difference, and then it's go time.
Yes.
Instead of having to wait twice as long because you didn't wait for it originally.
Like coming in, waiting, that was the perfect figure eight, I think.
Yeah.
It felt good.
Yeah, it was good.
Only thing I won't be able to do that with is the bug, the class 11. Yeah. That one's
well, that's a whole different animal.
Big slow turn. Smooth is fast, and that's a real true statement. You know, being patient, allowing the car to do it, you keep the momentum, keep the speed, and you're a lot faster.
Maybe just a little bit too much side to side.
So don't have fun. Take the fun out of it. Got it.
Where I see myself in the immediate next year and building up to is getting into the E-Class at the Nitro Cross. I really want to get into those 1,000 horsepower cars, and being here at Dirtfish and learning the ability of the cars is what I'm gearing up to do.
Well, a whole lot of shredding going on off track as well as on track. Woodward West activating out here. United States Air Force starting them young. They're flying high. Oh man, the Hoonicorn is in the building. That is one of my favorite car builds of all time. You know, it started out NA, then it went twin turbo. I know the Block kids over there, Kira, Leah, and Micah, they're over there signing autographs at that 43 Institute booth. But look at the lay of the land. This backdrop here is absolutely beautiful, and we are getting set. Again, moving on and advancing our road to the final here for our Group E. I'm Jared Dienda, joining you once again, Andrew Coley. You know what? The bottom half of you looks different, bud. You got a race suit on.
Get ready. Oh, no, God. most of the guys are not wearing race suits, but I want to take it seriously, Jeff. So I've got a race suit on, you know? Insurance basically said you have to wear a race suit, but nobody else is wearing a race suit. I look cheap. Wear a race suit. You wear it. Okay, fine, I'll wear a race suit.
Yeah. Wear this dumb hat.
This helmet.
Hey, guess what? Baja Bugs. These are absolutely awesome. I know my man J.H. Diesel is out there. He's going to be ripping around. He's in the orange bug. He's promoting, actually, Cletus McFarland's event. Cletus is having an event at Bristol Motor Speedway September 2nd and 3rd. But on that front row, you got Josh Felix, Scott Lasseter, Donald, Cowboy Cerrone. Got Todd Remery, Justin Hildebrand, Greg Shapiro, Donnie Donovan, Kyle Zirkus, Ryan Rodriguez, and Blake Wilkie. I'll tell you what, learning more about what these guys do, Donnie Donovan, Ryan Rodriguez, and Blake Wilkie, those are the ones really to watch. Donovan, that was the dude that did the little, again, not a bug, more of a cockroach, because he kept living. You can't kill a cockroach, baby, but they do an inverted order. So how you qualify, you go to the back of the pack just because, and it's going to shake things up. It's not a runaway race.
Why not?
Yep. So again, my man, J.H., J.H. is running the orange bug, and he's promoting the Bristol 1000. It's September 2nd and 3rd. So, Cole, you put on your pajamas. What, are you going to sleep, kiddo?
It's getting cold. You know, there's a bit of a breeze coming in. Just limbering up, ready for the 31-mile-an-hour beast.
I mean, are there any nerves at all in regards to the Van Breeze?
Yes. Massively.
Because you're going to be that good and you don't want to beat people up?
No, because it's the only car without any safety equipment whatsoever. They've even removed the airbag from the steering wheel. So, no cage, no racing seat, no harnesses.
You're Mr. Mega, dude.
It'll be fine.
Everything's fine.
Jim goes, do you want to go out the front of the grid? I said, did you hear me about the fact it won't come out of first gear? I was like, I'll go somewhere further down the grid. And I love the fact as well, there is no qualifying. There is no like, oh, this is the grid from qualifying today in the set. It's like, yeah, just go to the grid.
I'll
end up where I end up, and hopefully it's towards the rear, and I'll see if I can get it up into second gear.
I think we should do a Le Mans start. You know, put the vans across, you run towards it, and you pick whatever van you want.
Yeah. And you can't open the door either, so I've got to climb through the window, Dukes of Hazzard style.
All right, so here we go with our Baja Bugs finals. So again, we're looking at Josh Felix, Scott Lasseter, Donald Cowboy Cerrone, Todd Remery, J.H. Diesel. J.H. who? Yeah, Bristol 1000, Greg Shapiro, Donnie Donovan, Kyle Zirkus, Ryan Rodriguez, and Blake Wilkie. 10 seconds to send him, and here we go. It's slow, but it's, gosh darn it, it is fun. We saw some great racing last night, and here we go. NITRO, let's go and send it. Here we go. We are live at Utah Motorsports Campus, our Baja Bugs Finals, our doubleheader weekend, four laps.
Whoa, Wilkie quickly, nearly into the wall, right in the back of the pack.
Yeah, Wilkie gets pinched down, but like I said, Rodriguez, 1191 in the Continental Tires vehicle. Him and Donnie Donovan, they are the ones to watch.
I love the way the entire pack, Jared, has been almost split down the middle of the road there. On the outside line, five of them heading into the Joker Tire. They might go side by side in the Joker Tire. It's really not that wide down there, so let's see how that plays out.
Really deep, you know, in the down south in Baja, these things. They might not be fastest vehicles in the race, but guess what? They are steady and they can take a licking and keep on ticking.
They're so much fun, aren't they? Look. You can see having a look up the inside. Wilkins trying to make some moves. They jump well too, don't they? A lot of standard bodywork. They can change things like the dampers, but you can't change like the pickup points of the suspension. There's not a lot of trickiness underneath those cars. So the standard bodywork, so the one that rolled yesterday, they're just hammering it back out to get it straight again.
Scotty Dog out there. Scotty in the, that is the 1122. He's got the Dixon flannel, got the plaid out there. He's ripping around right now. And we're looking at Blake Wilkie, the baby blue.
Side there, but all the way around the inside. Now he's up the inside, look, making another move there. So Wilkie is making moves from the back of the grid already up, I think, into P3 and has Joker Jared as well. So now looking for P2, a little bit of contact. Come on now, Blake, give everyone else a chance. You might lose a place here.
Wilkie calls his beat on the slug sharp.
They may not be that much. They're not very fast, but they're a hell of a lot of fun. Okay, here we go down the straight, Jared. What do you reckon, flat out? I mean, we're quicker than my man, I know that.
Absolutely. Hey, J.H. is out front. He's running that Bristol 1000 graphic, promoting that event. His boy, Cletus McFarland.
going down here. Oh, and he gets a push. He gets a push from Rodriguez. He gets pushed out of the way.
And Wilkie already got him in turn two, so Wilkie made that pass for the lead, and then Wayne Grant White just got flattened into the wall. So, yeah, Blake Wilkie, we have seen him out front, starting from the back of the grid, and at the end of lap two, he's already into the lead.
But like I said, Ryan Rodriguez is definitely the guy to watch. He's there in the orange bug, but Blake Wilkie now up front. Now, keep in mind, Wilkie and Rodriguez, these guys will get into a tussle. Donovan right there, we're riding with him, the 1107. That's the bug that went end over end or side over side. He's repping that slow ride, and then he went to the slow roll yesterday. Great shots there by Justin Smash, our FPV pilot. Sometimes some would say it's their POV pilot. The 1143 right there, you see Todd Remmering. Remmering go by, push down a little bit. Wilkie sees the cabs on the inside line. Blake Wilkie hit that fastest lap. And we are just about at the halfway point.
He's done a 53.6 yard. Remmering's done a 53.7. 54.2 for Rodriguez in the 1191, which is the P2 car, I think, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, so Rodriguez is only...
Rodriguez, right there.
Yeah, so 6 tenths, sorry, just a lap time, but right there, like 7 tenths back on Wilkie. So we got a race on our hands here.
This is a real race, eh? And also, I encourage you, if you haven't seen it, Coley, and anybody listening, watch Urban Assault 3. It came out last week. This is a class 11, but I will tell you, it's a beefed-up bug, and he rips around the streets of Tijuana. So it's a bug on steroids, absolutely insane. But Rodriguez gets the pass, as you said, and he is getting lengths above Blake Wilkie.
I think Wilkie's got some sort of an issue. He's going slightly slower on the straight. But yeah, it's a great pass into turn one. Really tight to go. Oh, now Wilkie sends it. Get a bit of wheel on, trying to get a position back. Can't be tired in there, of course.
Rodriguez, Wilkie, and Zirkus. 1, 2, and 3. They've all hit their Joker lap. Donovan, oh, JH, stranded. But again, September 2nd and 3rd, Bristol 1000. Cletus McFarland, his event's going down at Bristol, the famous track.
Wilkie's going long on the jumps, isn't he? So much confidence in the car, plenty of seat time, just knows what it'll do. Now he looks to the inside line, going low on the berm. Wilkie trying to get back past Rodriguez. Rodriguez passed him really nicely up in turn one on the brakes.
Sometimes those pedals get stuck, you know, either brake or clutch.
That was what last time, remember?
Yeah, no, Oklahoma.
Was it the clutch pedal or the throttle pedal? That's the one job he was doing in between the events.
But Rodriguez blocking him out, lap 3 of 4. Gosh, look at the handwork in there. You see him working, just looking like he hit a beehive, you know, working his hands so much, swatting away bees. Oh, Wilkie taking the tighter line. Oh, wait, maybe too tight.
Loose, yeah, he's lost the momentum. He's top four of all joking, look, so Wilkie's lost some time. One lap to try and get through. And a spinner there out on the pavement section, end up on the inside line.
That's Greg Shapiro, the 1142, the Yellow Beetle. Rodriguez taking the title line. Wilkie, open her up. Guys, need to tie down. We are on the final lap. The white flag is out. Mercy rule, as I say. Rodriguez dominant here in the second half of this four-lap race. And here comes Rodriguez, clean, tidy, passing J.H. Who? J.H. Diesel, quite a different comparison to Group B coming off of that bank into that.
Taking the line, yeah, they all go quite high and try and maintain this speed through the corner. You haven't got 1,000 horsepower and all-wheel drive to pull you out of it. Watch Wilkie over the jump, long again. Look, that doesn't quite make it all the way to the down ramp.
They've got that thing pinned, man. All right, so here comes Rodriguez, Wilkie chomping at the bit, the slug shark coming on. He got a little loose on that back end, but Rodriguez got too much sauce.
I think if Wilkie had got the last corner right, Jarrett, so he could have carried a bit more pace on the straight, we might have seen a closer race on his last lap, but just gave up a little bit of time with that off-track skirt on the inside line, and they're not quite able to get back.
Looks like Rodriguez continues on. Wilkie in second. This is how they've been for quite some while. Donnie Donovan sits back there in fourth, and Kyle Zirkus sits in third.
Fun, isn't it? Rodriguez going to take it. Wilkie unable to match him this time round. Nice pass up in turn one. I reckon he'll be pleased with that.
And there's Big P.
Go on, Big P.
You can see that Dixon Flannel vehicle there. Scotty Dog running the Dixon Flannel.
delivery on that thing. A bit of late passing going on. Jared side by side from here, inside line now.
The Baja Vita jerky. That's not the right line. That's not where you're gonna take. If you're driving a minivan out there, what kind of line are you gonna take?
Whichever one is shortest, I reckon, if it'll only be in first, but we'll see. Let's see. You never know.
You got to get the kids to school, man.
Yeah,
you got to get them to soccer practice.
Yeah. We'll see. Five to six lucky fans if they want to come out in the battery. Don't think the insurance will cover that.
I think
that's
six unlucky fans.
Yeah, this.
Let's just call it what it is.
Who wants to ride at 29 mile an hour with six up?
All right, so there's JH going to get towed off there, the 1141. JH coming to us from Florida. He's a good friend of mine, again, promoting that Bristol 1000. You can see right there, he's getting towed off September 2nd and 3rd. Cletus McFarland's out here racing some Can-Ams. Got some turns in a group E, but this out ends. Ryan Rodriguez gets the win. Blake Wilkie, who got the win last night, gets second. Kyle Zirkus in third. Donnie Donovan for Todd Rimmery. Greg Shapiro, Scotty Dogg, Cowboy Cerrone doing double duty. JH and Josh Felix. All right, here are the highlights. Here is the start. Again, an inverted order. Those are the fastest vehicles. Go to the back of the pack. It's called inverted order. So even though Rodriguez and Wilkie were in the back of the pack, they came out on top. With Zirkus wrapping up that podium. A little tight in the beginning. Got some fashion. JH went into the wall.
Man. I reckon that's where the car got broke.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know, any sort of contact with these things, you never know. All right, well, there it is. Rodriguez gets the win.
Beautiful evening here in Utah, Salt Lake City. Well, I suppose Tuel is the closest town, isn't it? But Salt Lake City's a proper city.
Yeah,
so down the road.
Yeah, Salt Lake City.
Well, half an hour probably to Salt Lake City.
Half an hour is a major city.
Yeah.
Yep, Salt Lake City is the major airport fly-in. Up and over the hill is Park City. Beautiful backdrop here. Thanks for joining us. Nitro Cross, there's some groupie action. Don't go anywhere.
Let's go set it.
All right, well, we've seen a lot of different calamity going on from, you know, we saw the Baja Bugs, we've seen the side-by-sides, NX Next, Group E, and now we are looking at more Group E action. These are the standings after last night's festivities. Kevin Erickson assumes the lead. Andreas Backrud and Pastrana, 1-2-3.
20 points, that's including the points from today, Jared, the qualifying points, because Kevin only led by 5 points last night. He's now got a 20-point lead. Shows you how important the qualifying section of the day is. All those points up for grabs, and he got the TQ, so... Yeah, that's a decent number. He can afford to have a bit of a shocker later on. Remember, he's on pole, isn't he? He's having a great day so far. He won't want what happened to Conor Martell yesterday. He had the perfect day, and it all went wrong in the final. So it's not a done deal yet, and we still got the last shot to qualifiers to go as well.
Absolutely, a big shocker there. Fraser McConnell having a tough go here in Utah.
Yeah.
Up till this point, it very well could change until now. You know, we're seeing some more Jamaican flags just pop up around our family room. You know, Stephanie, his mom, just slid in one, and now they keep multiplying like gremlins, but they are awesome Jamaican flags. So we got some guests joining us here.
We have, yeah, we're gonna have a chat with them.
Awesome.
We've got our Pit Viper party animals down here. And we've got two lads here as well who've come all the way from France to come and watch Andreas Backrud. So we'll have a chat with them in a second.
Awesome.
Yeah, super cool.
Yeah, the sun is setting here, and here is how the road to the final is shaping up. Talking about Andreas Backrud and Kevin Erickson. Like you said, Erickson, he gets pole position because he got TQ and he won his heat. Tanner Faust, who failed to make the final yesterday, is now locked his way into the final. And then again, we'll get the semifinal winner. And then we got LCQ, easy for me to say, P1, P2, so on and so forth. All right, the Pit Viper.
Party animals.
Party animals.
Are you gonna see the Pit Viper party animals?
What's going on? How are we doing?
Coming in for a look around.
Yeah, awesome. These guys can't. Look at this. Back
these guys coming in. There we go. Here we are. You need to go and see with the boys.
Yeah,
go see with the boys. There we are. So these two lads run the French Andreas Backrud fan club page, and they came to Trois-Rivières and watched the ice race, and they've traveled all the way from France here to Salt Lake City, and they're absolutely loving the gap jump here. So, yeah, good to see you, lads. Good effort. Yeah.
All right, so here we are. They got the VIP seats up here in the family room, and this is what we're looking at, Group E LCQ1. So Robin Larson, Connor Daly on that front row, Ollie Bennett, and Benito Guerra. How many cars are moving on?
What's two from this one. So
yeah,
two from the first
blow.
LCQ, three from the second one. So half this field is not going to make the cut for the final. This will be the last time they're out on track here at Utah Motorsport Campus. Daly on that front row, wanting to get into turn. He's repping the Jamaican flag. Looks like Stephanie McDonald's been to put a flag on the roof of that as well.
She is a busy, busy gal, you know, between making some amazing rum drinks and throwing out some Jamaican flags. We are ready to party. You can see again. Larson has had a tough go as well here this weekend, you know, kind of getting some tussles, everything, what's going on.
They're in a good position, aren't they, if they're on the front row for Daly and Larson. You'd like to think running out of the same tent, DRRJC, they might have had a chat about what the plan is to turn one, but we are about to find out, and of course, they've got to nail the start first. So Daly jumped the start, saw it straight away.
Yeah.
He's gone, he hasn't realized he's gonna have to go back, so they'll be on the radio to him. Don't do a whole lap, Connor, come on now. Let's go back. That's enough now. It was a good try.
Slap on the hand.
Yeah.
He's like, dude, I'm doing it. I got one heck of a hole shot.
So it'll be a double joker lap for Connor Daly, and that's going to play into the hands of Guerra on the back row. Definitely.
Yeah, so explain that again. If you jump, what's the repercussion?
So if you jump the start, the first person to jump the start has to do two joker laps. If anybody else jumps the start now, they'll immediately be withdrawn from the race. So he's... Okay, we're hearing 5-second penalty. It used to be double joker, so that's what race control have said to us, so that's the decision. Fine, it's pretty much the same as a second joker.
Absolutely, absolutely.
The only thing is, don't get the track positioning quite the same way. Look at that, amazing crowd here today.
Club Nitro got some VIPs up in the building. Like I said, Brandon Steinecker, my homie drummer from Rancid, good friend of Ken Block, his lovely lady Danielle, and some other friends and family in the building. The 43 Institute, I don't know if you know about it.
Yeah, dude,
yeah,
fantastic.
A great activation, yeah. Raising money. Their first activation is going to be getting helmets, not just for motorsports, but for action sports.
Yeah, and you know, to underprivileged kids BMX. As well who maybe can't afford to, you know, exactly. Their action sports, but haven't got the dollars to go and buy a helmet. I think it's a really cool thing to do.
Yeah, check it out. It's called the 43 Institute on Instagram or the website.
43i.org, I think.
Yes,
if I remember
sir.
Correctly. So yeah, go find it. You can find it by Blockhouse Racing as well. Head to Lucy Blocks, Instagram, Leah Blocks, you'll find it. Yep. Yeah, it's great stuff. They've been donating checks as well to people in rally who have that spirit of rally that Ken Block loves so much. Yeah, not maybe a pro up the front, but someone who's scratching around for budget, yep, and running the car themselves, taking it on a trailer to the events. It's great. Go look it up.
Yep, KB forever. All right, 30 seconds, the countdown begins. And again, that 5-second addition to their time. So Connor Daly's really gonna need to put in the work, and to be quite honest, he's gonna need to see some mistakes in his rearview mirror. Larson Daly on that front row. Benito Guerra on that back, right next to
Ollie Bennett.
And Ollie Bennett.
Good news for Bennett and Guerra, then that penalty for Daly. Remember, a 5-second penalty according to race control to be added at the end of the race. Nitro lights comes on, wait for the green, send it, and then watch for the start. It's a good start on the inside by Larson. Daly was super cautious because he jumped the start already. Drops back to P4. Bennett goes into the inside line. Larson's gone in there as well. Guerra leads around the standard lap. They're going to head for the big gap jump. But Robin Larson leading on that joker lap. Can they get out in front? It's a pretty small gap, and it was a bad start, remember, for Daly.
Yeah,
so Larson might take the lead here from the joker. Guerra's just going to get there before him, but only just.
Connor Daly does get in that second position, but mind you, you dropped back to third. Thank you very much. So again, confusing the vehicles there, the black livery, and they're in a second. Robin Larson with the completion of the Yokohama Tire Joker Lap. Benito, see him flick it on in. Finished fourth last night, would love to get on the podium. He won his first heat here today, so he's feeling confident. He's got a smile on his face after kind of a timid, he had to withdraw out in Oklahoma. He went out very, very confident.
He was really nice on his chat. He was freaking out about the jumps. He couldn't get the jumps right, couldn't get the rhythm right, couldn't butter the landings. Oh, Bennett up the inside of Daly there. So he makes a pass up into P3, and I saw Benito, and he was like, I'm loving it. With the huge gap jump here, I think he thought he might freak out. He nailed that, and afterwards, he was like, you know what, it's all in my head.
Absolutely.
And with P4 yesterday, great result.
It's like going off the high dive when you're a kid, right? You're like,
yeah,
I got this, man. Just jump.
Those guys are going to go a long way, though, Benito. Still
Ooh, that's
Daly on the inside line. So Connor Daly's gone into the joke lap this time round, so going to hope to try and get an undercut on Bennett. Benito's a little bit short on the tabletop there. Larson's right there, but Larson's not going to take any risk. Does need to watch out for Bennett behind him, because Bennett will want to try and make a pass here. Two cars going through at the minute. Ollie Bennett might make it if Wenguera goes joking, in which case both of the XI cars will be in today, where neither of them made it yesterday.
Yeah, great point, great point. So again, Benito needs to gain some ground over these guys, taking the top two cars. About to approach the white flag and that final lap. So many turns, 1.4 miles in total, 65% drivers are really loving this course.
If I was Bennett's spotter, I'd be on the radio to him telling you need to get onto the back bumper of Larson and just follow him. The gap's tight, it's 1.1. The Joker Delta has been as little as 1.2. So you're looking at 2.2 Guerra, who's probably going to come out of the merge super close with the British driver, Ollie Bennett. Larson goes out to the white line because he knows Guerra's going early on the brakes and into the Joker. Bennett a little bit squirrely on the brakes now. Now Bennett closes the gap down to Larson. Guerra is sideways on the run into the Joker lap. Here we go, all about the merge now. Remember, the top three make it through to the final. Top two.
Benito definitely needs to be tidy here. You saw him hard on the brakes, now going to the tabletop. Let's see what kind of attitude. He does not clear it, and I believe Benito will drop in. That contributed to him dropping in time. So Larson and Bennett out front. Guerra slides into third, and Connor Daly in fourth. So still a few turns left to go, but if they keep it tidy, it should be Larson and Bennett into the final. All right, so it looks like they're just going to go in running order, and like you said, getting to the back bumper.
Andreas backwards in the commentary box with. So Andreas, your teammate's about to take this one and stick himself into the final. Larson comes through the left-hander. Going to flick him around to the right now. Bennett hoping to go with him. Guerra, I think he's too far back, barring any mistakes. So Larson coming up over the tabletop. Last year's Nitro Cross champion. Booking his spot in the final here in round three. Utah Motorsports Campus. He goes through along with Ollie Bennett. Both the XI cars make the cut. Andreas, that's your teammate in. That's a great result for you guys.
It definitely is. I mean, it's crucial for the team championship. We're up there fighting for that. Robin did a perfect race here.
Har du någon kommentar om banan?
Did the Joker the first lap and then kept on.
Yeah, he didn't need to make a move, did he?
No, he didn't.
The top two drivers finish on to the final, and that is Robin Larson and Ollie Bennett are advancing on to the finals, and alongside Andreas Backerud, Kevin Erickson, and that of Tanner Faust. So congratulations to Larson and Bennett. Unfortunately, Benito Guerra and Connor Daly, their weekend is done. Let's take a look at it here again. Unfortunately, Connor Daly with a delayed start after he had that jump start. He had that 5-second delay, so he had a lot of work out ahead of him, but regardless, he was in the back of the pack.
Yeah, Bennett got through there, didn't he, in the second to last corner, sticking himself up into P3. And then it was just a case of getting as close to Larson as he possibly could.
That's a long jump from Bennett.
Yeah,
I can tell you.
He's a motocross guy, isn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah,
yeah. When we first came here, and I think it was when he came with the Mini, I think, yeah. And I was like, you scared? Liam Doran was also not scared of the jump. Liam said it's just science, which was a fair point. You know, so it's just,
But it's not just science, because you have to.
He's over there. There he is.
You have to feel the speed.
There he is. You guys can come in. Come and have a seat. Come and have a seat in here. Liam Doran, we've got
Blake
Wilkie over there as well.
Amanda Sorensen, Liam Doran.
Come on, get in. Come on.
Just sit on the couch.
Come in here. Come and sit down. Oh, God.
All right. Hey, Andrew.
Thanks,
see you later, buddy.
Yeah, cheers.
Good luck.
Best of luck.
Good luck,
Andrew Coley for president, bro.
Right, have fun.
You're fine. You're fine.
I think,
fine.
Lee, I'm going to
over the jump. Just like,
mate, it's if it. I'm hoping
hold
it
your breath.
Yeah.
Compress. Bum.
Okay.
Breathe out.
Okay.
I mean, he's not hitting the gap, dude.
Yeah. I'm
no, right, no,
okay.
But there is other jumps.
All right.
This car doesn't have much of springs or dampers.
All right.
I'll leave you with another Brit, Jared. Liam's here.
Yeah, Liam's here. Diana might jump in. Blake, Wilkie, Amanda. I don't know. Maybe we sit on the couch when the Van Prix's going on, and we'll all create some banter over here. So again, Coley suited and booted. Well, I don't know if Vans are booted, but are those fireproof? Are those fireproof ankle socks? I've never seen those.
Vans.
Yeah. Vans. Yeah. Van. Got it. I get it. Well, somebody, I believe, vandalized your vehicle as well. So we'll take a look at that out
of luck, Skins.
Good luck, homeboy. All right.
Oh, we got. I can't believe he's going.
All right. All right, so again, we've seen a lot of drivers succeed. Some drivers having a bit of a tough time. Coming to this round of competition, the Jamaican driver, Fraser McConnell, was leading the pack. So let's learn some more about the Jamaican pilot, Fraser McConnell. Let's see. Big ups, Fraz.
The first and only Jamaican to win an America's Rallycross Championship. McConnell's pace is second to none, except to maybe his pal Usain Bolt. He's one of Jamaica's most popular sporting icons, and his popularity has followed him to the Nitrocross paddock. Only in his sixth season of Rallycross, this speedster is super fast, even in the snow, and shows no signs of slowing down.
It's been an absolutely brilliant performance by the Jamaican. First ever Nitro Rallycross victory for Fraser McConnell.
It's a perfect event, baby.
First driver in Nitro Rallycross history to get three TQs. Fantastic.
With big wins to his name last season, this cool-headed Caribbean could be too hot to handle this year. Kiss the egg, baby.
And here we go with LCQ. This is Group E LCQ 2. So we're taking three drivers from this group. Connor Martell on the front row next to his teammate, Travis Pastrana, and Fraser McConnell and Ollie Erickson. This is a very, very stacked group. I mean, look at Connor Martell. Andreas Backer is gonna be my co-host here.
Yeah.
You're gonna play me. I'm gonna try to get, you know, as fast and frivolous as Andrew Coley does. I can definitely do that, but he always likes to take the lead, so I'll let him do
there
it.
There we go, Nitro.
Let's go. Here we go, on that front row, Vermont sports car. Again, Travis Pastrana, Connor Martell, Ollie Erickson on that back row. And Fraser McConnell, it's a Vermont sports car sandwich with Brad in the middle. It looks like Connor Martell is going for that Joker lap. So here we go for the other three drivers, Pastrana, McConnell, and Ollie Erickson.
Insane start by Fraser McConnell.
That was
from
bold.
Back row all the way to the first into the first corner. It's insane.
Is that a bold move? Do you agree with that?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's doing what he needed to do.
All the drivers really flicking it in there, throwing it in sideways. Connor Martell in the back of the pack, but
Travis
he takes
wide.
It early on. Travis goes wide. He's throwing that car very sideways. And now Fraz out front. I feel like he's driving with a lot of aggression, a lot of frustration. He needs to calm those nerves, right? I mean, what do you think's going through his mind?
Remember, top three goes through to the final. Right now, Travis is in the weak spot. He has 1.2 up to Fraser there, and he's under pressure.
All right, so Fraser McConnell out front. So look at that flicking in. There goes Ollie Erickson. Connor Martell taking a straight line approach. And then you can see Travis Pastrana, We the People holsters vehicle.
I love the onboard shots.
And it's just getting darker. Everybody kind of seeing what race line they have.
Look how tight it is.
Yeah,
1.
I mean, this
6.
And this is what Ollie said. He's like, you know,
1.2, don't
we have lunch right before this. And Ollie says, dude, look at the LCQ. Look who's in it. Ollie Erickson trying to tidy it up. And there he goes. Now he's going to take that Yokohama tire.
Travis spins.
Travis spins out. Travis Pastrana, winner of yesterday's event. All signs are saying he's going to be out. But we have 1.5 laps left. Wide swing. And Connor Martell gets in the tires, gets into that wall. Oh, now look at this.
Did he do the same as the NASCAR dude did? Like, hit the rail all the way through?
Looks like he bounced out. I know what you're talking about. Looked like Connor Martell rode the wall after he went over that big gap jump. But Connor Martell, he kind of takes himself out. We'll see if Pastrana can gain some ground. But remember, Fraz had it in the back earlier.
Yeah.
Suspension broken. He finds himself
stuff
out here in the kiss.
You know, but he's got Uncle Sal all over the car, and I'm sure it's going to finish up this race.
Well, fingers crossed for him. I know he's your DRR teammate, driver in Ribold Racing.
Yeah.
So Fraz, again, Joker predictor, what do we got? Can he hold on to it?
Sure.
They're saying he's going to hold on to it. So he's going to retain the lead, 2.3 seconds over Ollie Erickson. That is a considerable gap.
All they need is a clean Joker. Not over sideways there. Dirt, there's a bump there, you brake just on top of it. Angle the car perfect in the Joker over the jump. Oh, He landed a bit short, but that was good.
Wow, yeah, actually he did kind of salvage that. Really well done. Right there, tire barrier, yeah, evading that. So Fraser McConnell still holding on to it. Ollie Eriksson holding in the second position.
I know they are true to the final.
Whoa, big jump there by Fraz.
Fraz is a big sender.
Yeah, he definitely sends it and really noses down. Good attitude of the car. You can see him just inputting that steering wheel. Nice inputs. Kids running around to see what's going on. You can see that. And there you see Martel in the background, 13 seconds back. Pastrana out. What a turn of events. TQ for Connor Martel. Yeah. All signs are saying he's going to get the win. Pastrana gets the win last night, and here we are.
I mean, Connor can still win the final. He's in it.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, Fraser here coming over the last jump. He's been so unlucky all day. Good to see him up there.
All right, so there we are. We are seeing Fraser McConnell, Ollie Eriksson. All right, so round three, Group E, LCQ.
I mean, what happened there?
Yeah,
Travis spun in turn two, lap two. Connor hit the wall, did a wall ride.
Uh-huh. And there's the checkered flag.
Yeah, still rolling.
Yeah, still rolling, which is a good sign. But Pastrana, he is out. Let's take a look back. I really liked how you kind of scrutinized and diagnosed kind of what was going on there with Fraser McConnell. But Fraser McConnell, smile's going to be on his face. He is going to the final. Fraser McConnell, Ollie Eriksson taking. And then Connor Martel, yeah, so he gets that third spot. So, all right, so Pastrana is out. So congratulations to him. But Diana Dahlgren down with the superstar, the Van Prix, Mr. Mega Andrew Coley.
Our Van Prix superstar, Andrew Coley, you are looking forward to absolutely crushing the competition tonight with the minivan series. Walk us through what's going to happen tonight.
Well, I'm going to go off the line, probably find that the car won't go into second gear, and I reckon everyone's going to come past me. But, you know, I talk a good game in the commentary box, so I best get out of there and have a crack at it at night. It's going to be good fun.
We heard that the van hits a max speed of 31 miles per hour.
Well, that's, yeah, if it stays in first, if I can sneak into second, maybe we can get 50 down the straight here. But it's, you know, I got the Union Jack on there. That's going to add a couple of miles an hour, I think, as well. And the atmosphere down here, I have to say, is unbelievable. Watching the race from here and not being in the announcer's booth, the noise from the fans when the guys are coming past, it's a great show.
Yeah, the fans have showed up. Big turnout tonight here. Utah, thank you so much. It's been electric down here on the grid. What do you think these fans think?
Well, from the noise they're making, they're having an absolutely brilliant time. Bit of a shocker there to see neither of the Vermont sports cars making it. Fraser McConnell, I think, would be in a better mood than he was in earlier on. The Jamaicans made it through to the final. So, yeah, so many quick drivers, anyone's.
We'll see Coley out there in the Van Prix. Take it away, guys.
Well, we are here in the family room. We're watching the Van Prix go down. I feel like we need snacks, nachos, glizzies. Adult beverages. I mean, adult beverages for Blake. Congratulations on the win. Didn't get it done today. How fun is it and how rad is it to have the Baja Bugs out here at Nitro Circus and not part of the Nitro family?
It's the best. It's the rawest. It's the realest. And it's the cheapest. I mean, we race all across the Southwest deserts. And to come out here, it's fun. I'm sure it's entertaining.
Yeah, no, everybody's loving it. You know, obviously, you know, it's a great introduction to Baja Bugs and the Class 11, the whole story. Ledbetter, how are we doing? How are we feeling over there?
Not so bad. We're doing pretty good. We finished third in the last one, so now we're going to see how the next one goes.
There you go. That's it. And take a look at Coley. Who's rooting for Coley? Who's rooting against him?
I am rooting for Coley.
Of course you are. He's got the Union Jack flag.
I am here representing
Britain. Coley drinks Coley. Hot dog water. Okay. Well,
I heard rumors that you can only go into first gear in that car.
Yeah, he can only go 31 miles per hour. So
he's starting first.
Who else is racing out there?
Clean, we got my boy, J.H. Diesel, out there racing. Probably going to get a W.
Who's that?
J.H. is pretty experienced when it comes to minivans. You know, he grew up in one. I'm pretty sure he was born in one, in fact.
Yeah.
And maybe the list goes deeper. But J.H. in a minivan. I think he's going to pull down a W right here.
All right. We got Ollie Eriksson in the building, the Sorensen. Look at Fraz. Now he's happy. Look at this guy. He could have punched a baby earlier. Now he's looking like he is absolutely elated. Fraz, I mean, I think your mom's, you know, Jamaican voodoo. Congratulations, doggy. You got it done. Tanner Faust is joining us. Ollie Eriksson, the Sorensen, brother and sister. Amanda, how's your experience been out here at Nitro?
Great. Yesterday I was driving the car. I podiumed, which was super awesome. Brandon was in my ear spotting, and today we swapped roles. So Brandon's driving the car, and I'll be in his ear spotting.
Absolutely. That's great. So, Brandon, you're feeling good out here? You having fun?
Oh, yeah. You know, we started dead last in the last heat, and we made it up to P5. So hopefully we can continue that momentum, make up a couple more spots, and end up on the podium.
Awesome. Tanner? All this craziness, you know, just Rallycross, just over the years progressing, and now just, you know, from the pit parties to minivans racing.
You know, it's an evolution. It's an evolution. Some would say this is the peak when you have Dodge Caravans head-to-head, you know, with Odyssey. It's really a battle of the brands, battle of the manufacturers here.
Yep.
I'm a big fan of Stow & Go Storage from the Dodge Caravan.
Yes.
Yeah, it's about efficiency, but you know, some people are just going to go hard. I think the Honda Pilot probably has the most power.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, Coley's got some skills too. A lot of people are going to underestimate Coley, so I'm a big Coley fan.
I mean, he's a big drink of water, a big drink of hot dog water is what it is. How's the TR family doing over there? How's your whole experience going on? And
man, I can't. I'm pretty thankful. We've been running second place all weekend long, and we're getting pushed to our limits. Trying my best, and we're gonna go out the final and send it. So
heck yeah.
And Dad's out there sending it in the bug.
Look at Coley. Diana, this is your first. This is your first event. I think he's got wiener schnitzel on the door, hot dog water in his gut. And he's got a kitty, he's got Jamaican. I don't know what he's representing here overall.
You know what? We are the most successful announcing tripod here.
Yeah.
No matter what happens, I fully support my boy. My boy.
Yeah. Just let's root for Coley. I mean, you know.
How many radiators do you think are going to get taken out in the first lap? Oh, are they hitting that big table in the back?
I don't know the spec of what's going on here. I just know that one has AstroTurf on it. Another has a GH. Yeah, Scotty Dog's got the AstroTurf on it. And who else? Any other names
Jim
out there that you're
Yeah, what about Jim?
Jim York. Jim York. Are you pulling for Jim? Are the Sorensen's pulling for?
I mean, I don't know. He's got to recover after the Glen Helen race that he had.
Yeah.
The corkscrew? I think he's got something up his sleeve. Every time that dude wants to put on a show. So, last lap, keep an eye on Jim.
I don't know if anybody else is racing this thing. We're so focused on Andrew Coley. The school buses are pulling up. The whiskey throttle.
I really think whoever finishes with all four wheels is probably going to win.
Yep. Well, this is the elite moment of Nitro Cross this weekend. There's only one race to rule them all, and one minivan will remain supreme. The series continues on Nitro Cross.
Yeah, Brent.
We'll see this in Phoenix as well.
So you got Brent from PFI Speed there,
That's
too.
That's right. I didn't even know he was here until I saw the livery.
Oh, Brent is a savage.
Oh.
That guy can drive.
You know, I mean, at Bristol, right? At Bristol 1000.
Yeah, I know he has several children, so you know he's had minivan experience.
We have a special pit board person, and it's a 30-second card person. Oh, I thought it was going to be somebody else. Oh, but it's Bilko. Bilko's our card gal.
Were there any special entry requirements for this class?
Really none. Really,
really none.
Whenever there's a card, you know, now he's playing the guitar. Now, no, there were not any special requirements. Basically, remove the interior, leave one seat in, remove the airbags. Jim York last year forgot there was an airbag at your shins, and he blew out his shins. It was terrible. Never knew there was a shin bag, but he found it.
Jim York, I mean, really went hard to make this happen. I mean, how do you buy that many minivans in just 1.5 days?
I guess Utah and
that's impressive.
Utah's got a lot
of really
minivans.
Made it happen. So JH gonna go to the front though, confident.
Okay. All right,
we got Bilko because the Gabby card girl is racing.
Yep, that's
Gabby's
right.
Gabby's racing.
Wow, she's doing a great job too.
So Gabby is racing. She is again card gal and then now racing.
Okay, I see JH third row in the 88 van right there.
Look at this cast right here.
Yeah, look at this.
Look at this rat pack, dude. Throwing it up like such a good group of cats.
Are we the announcers for this, Jared?
I want you guys to talk smack. Like I was like, let's just have some fun. That's what it's about. I'm not gonna name names. Travis joining us over here. I thought you were gonna put the booty shorts on. Travis, just I don't know, crop a squat somewhere.
Down.
Travis Pastrana. We are getting ready to send it. Travis, we thought you were going to be the card girl. We had the perfect, you know.
Oh, we got Bilko out there though. He's got he's got way better hip swivel.
Yeah, he does. He does.
Ten
all right.
Seconds,
oh, he's flipping. Oh,
Bilko's showing looking so good.
Surprised he's not holding it upside down.
Right. Let's make it. Oh, he laughs.
There we go.
Let's make him clap. Let's go. NITR, let's go. Van Pree here in Utah. Send it. Let's go. On that front row, Andrew Coley gets smoked. Brent PFI speed.
Come on, Coley. Come on.
Charging to the front. Coley's stuck in first gear.
He only has first gear.
Oh.
Dang.
All right.
Yeah, that
so
first gear is slowing him down.
Coley, you know, probably the oldest cat out there. Let's be quite honest.
Cuts the track.
A perfect line.
Okay, who's out front? Who do we have out front? Who is that? That's the Whiskey Throttle Gang. And there's Brent PFI speed. Holy cow.
Oh my god.
Whoa. Yeah, we got sparks in the building too.
These things have got some real good suspension.
I like the headlights. I think it adds a nice touch.
The handling is jumping.
Big table. Diesel, you think they're going to lift off this big table coming up?
Yeah, I want to hear your guys' banter.
Someone's losing a radiator.
We got Jim York. Gabby's out there. Clint Bybee. Of course, we got the Colton Bybee.
Nobody's
got
it.
Nobody, dude.
PFI took it easy.
Okay, so they're salvaging their vehicles to make sure they have attrition. Don't know the specs. Can we talk to our race directors? How many laps? How many laps, Trav? Two laps?
It just makes you realize how fast the race vehicles are when you see a regular van going around the track.
Where's Coley when we need him? Come on, Coley.
Coley's going to be
in. I may stand corrected. It may be four laps.
There he is.
Have you ever read the book, The Tortoise and the Hare? I had no idea the tortoise was English.
Oh, hope he cuts the track.
Perfect lines.
I saw Jim pulling off vacuum lines on the bottom of it. So there's a sticker on the bottom.
Dog, he is laced out in turf. Look at that, man. That van's probably 250 pounds in turf on it.
Diesel Dave is out there. We got Jim York. Oh, boy. Scotty Dog, fresh off of racing the Bugs.
Do we know which one's Gabby?
Gabby is. Let's see which rod she's in.
Yeah, they need to throttle down. I mean, the leader.
Hey, we still got three laps.
Got the school bus out there. Oh, JH going for the pass on PFI speed, dude. Brent. Oh, they're getting some contact into the hay bales.
Oh, and he got a little push.
By speed off the track, brother.
Oh,
we
man.
We have a joker lap.
Tough break. No
and there's
joker.
Some bad blood between JH and Brent.
You know, they've been a longtime rivalry.
Yep.
And I think Brent beat him in a fist fight once. And now JH tries to return in a van.
Well, here's the blessing is Andrew Coley will not be finishing last. Yeah, let's go, Coley.
What a guy.
What a ledge. Oh my gosh! That is Andrew. Oh, Brent's coming back.
Brent is back. Let's go.
Don't count him out. Last. Don't count him out. Coley might still be last.
Who's the cow?
The cow's into the wall is what it is. Broken front right suspension. Don't know who the cow spotted one was.
A little bit of debris there on the track. Not worth stopping for.
Oh, Coley just cruising right now.
He could have pulled over and stowed and go'd that part.
He had too many glizzies before he started. Washed down with the water.
Who's our leaders here? Is that Jade chasing down the leader?
I believe it's the Whiskey Throttle Boys. Don't know which one it is.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out who's in the school bus. Here comes JH coming in hot on the leader. My boy. Oh, look at that line. JH going a little wide again, dude. Just what he did in the bug race.
He's going for the takeoff up there.
I feel like we're on lap 20. We may still be on the second.
Coley.
We're on the third.
Right into the fans. That's a Coley.
God save the Coley. Doesn't know what country he's
from. Oh, here we go. JH with the pressure.
He's drafting.
Get the inside, Justin. Get the inside, Jade.
I think the track's a little too wet for him. You know, it's just might be too slick.
You know, I think Jade set up the suspension on his minivan to run a little wider in the turns.
man, Coley.
Camera guy, we need to go back to the leader shop.
We got eyes on Coley.
All right, in car with Coley.
We need to get back now.
All right, let's get back to that leader. Let's get back to that leader. Who's leading the race?
We missed it.
There we go.
We're back.
Justin really put some time on that last race.
We got the checkered flag. This is the last lap. Who's coming to the top? One of the Whiskey Throttle
Cats. Make a move, JH. Make a move, Justin. Make a move.
JH going for it.
Oh, that's it.
Let's see that J turn, dude. Let's get aggressive. There's AstroTurf from Scotty Dog. Oh no, it looks like there's a checkered flag.
That's checkered?
That is checkered. That's a checkered flag. Big B waves it. And Andrew Coley gets the win.
That school bus was playing with it.
Gets the win for being the worst.
The school bus was toying with JH. I think he had a lot more in the tank. Yeah. Just let him catch him.
One more lap and JH would have had that. I don't know what happened to Jim York. The guy in the school bus won. Unclear.
Does anyone know who won that?
That may have been Jim York, to be honest. Unclear.
Unclear.
Coley's still going.
I thought Jim York was in the American flag.
This track is so big.
It might be Clinton Bybee or Colton Bybee. I know they were the Whiskle.
Drone down.
Did the drone just get hit?
All right, so.
Let's hear it for Coley coming into the finish.
Andrew Coley, oh, drone almost going in the cockpit. The Van Prix, an absolute calamity. Clean up all through the course. And Coley popping it off. Oh, he's ghost riding the whip. Coley crossing the line.
What a showman.
An absolute throw in the shotgun, hanging loose. Oh, the drone landing on the ride.
I think we crashed the drone.
All right, so the Whiskey Throttle Cats. Big moments. Oh, we got some fluids out there on track. We'll get Coley back here in just a moment. So are we ready to enter the Van Prix class? No?
Where was that on the
I'm line? Actually ready. I'm ready to enter the Van Prix class.
Right?
The pinnacle of the sport.
The power these
things are putting out is just unreal.
Yeah. You know, there's F1, then there's Van Prix.
I think we need a little bit more carnage next time. Yep. So maybe I could be the right ingredient.
That was probably the biggest moment there, where Coley thought he was gonna not be last. Little AstroTurf on the roof. The cow ran in to the wall. Big moment, Bilko showing his rear end to the start. And Brent PFI speed, like I said, Coley thought he was not gonna be last, but it ended up ending that way. An exciting turn of events here for the Van Prix. Whiskey Throttle comes out on top. They have the school bus that ruined my birthday, my cake. We need a big round of applause for when Coley comes back in, because he's gonna need a little uplifting here. And he's making his way through the pits. He's gonna be coming past all the Can-Ams over there, the Rival Motorsports, the Can-Ams. He's got his suit on. He actually has, I believe, a water bottle full of that hot dog water. Coley, make your way over here, buddy. Oh, he's signing autographs. Oh, Leticia asking for an autograph. He did it.
While we're waiting for him to get here, you guys should hear the trash talk between Pastrana and Cletus right here.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, they got some bets going on with these side-by-side racing, and TR's getting in on it too.
Remoried, you throwing out some, we got some cashola, little side bets going
right
now?
You guys got something going on in the side-by-side class?
So I've been behind the Eagle all day, but I've only had two laps where the K&M, because he stole my K&M because he was ejected from the other race. Too much America. So, too much freedom. So we're debating if the vehicle that's on the side is the display K&M. I tried to get that running today. It ran for two laps, and then it's like basically a fault's going off. But I think so. I am saying that I can start last and still catch you.
There is no chance that if I start P4, you'll catch me. So whatever bet you would like to set up,
I'm going to go ahead and change my answer. I'm going to take my hometown boy from Omaha. I'm going to put $1 on Cletus.
That's my brother, dude.
All right, so that's
– I got $1 on Cletus.
Now
– I'm putting $1 on Trav.
Bro, okay. Wilkie, what
I'm putting $1 on Trav.
All right, so all the side-by-side
cats. Let's run it then.
So I don't know. They got the whole thing apart. If they got something else.
Yeah.
They got another one.
All right, so we got a battle going on. Side-by-sides are up pretty quick here.
Yeah. Well, here it is. He's coming in. Big round of applause for Coley coming in. Oh, last place. You did it, kiddo. You did it. Congratulations.
Oh yeah.
Diana, let's have some let's have some words with our last place finisher.
Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out.
Oh, steps outside of that absolute weapon of a machine. Coley standing on it. Celebrating with a bottle of hot dog water.
Yeah.
Congratulations. The pride of England, holding it down.
Can't go run in the studio with my microphone.
Thank you. Goodness, Meg, honestly.
Coley,
what a job, eh?
What?
Yes, thank you, man. Oh, my
From
goodness.
Zero to hero. Gets it done.
I know, man. I know. Thank you, man. That's so nice.
Oh, my gosh. Here we are with the Nitro Cross Hero. You did it. My partner in crime. Did you see the roof? Did you? I did not know that you were fueled by hot dog water.
I think Z might have a
You got multiple microphones. Do you even know what you're doing anymore? You go race once during
That's
Nitro
better.
Cross, and you lose all inhibition.
Mate.
I mean, let me just
represent. You
yeah,
know?
Put that thing on.
There was, you know.
You thought you weren't going to get last place, but you ended up getting last place.
Well, one van retired out the back, so second to last. It was pretty disappointing off the start. I did try and get it in second gear, and it wouldn't have it. And then at that point, I was like, I think it might be game over. But still got some air. I noticed people breaking on the crest. So I didn't really break the tabletop. You know, that was a harsh landing on every lap. I nearly went off the side of the jump coming onto the straight. I was like, dude, no. But it was funny. I'll tell you what was lovely is I could hear the crowd up at the far grandstand going absolutely mental every time it came around. Justin smashed nearly through the window. Yep. I heard him land on the roof at one point.
Yep.
So.
Yep.
What a great time. It's so much fun. Thank you to everyone out there for the support. Like, driving up to the grid was just brilliant. Yeah, good stuff.
Absolute legend. Coley from zero to hero in everybody's hearts. Oh, congratulations all around. Don't go anywhere. Nitro Cross action continues here at Utah Motorsports Campus.
Yokohama Tire. Make every drive a performance. My Energy. Driving the charge to a sustainable future. Rumble, bold and free. GoPro, official camera of the Nitro Cross.
Getting ready for Nitro Cross next. And here we are taking a look at this grid. A lot of talent here. The next final on that front row. They finished 1 and 2 previously. And here is where they stand. Kasper Janssen, Leah Block. Second row, Jimmy Henderson and Patrick Grutzka. And then finally, last row, Eric Gordon and Lane Vaquela. Lane Vaquela getting into that last heat to ensure that he could still be in the hunt for that championship. He had a great weekend in Oklahoma, a little tough break here last night, but right now I'll tell you what, a lot of eyes on Leah Block and Casper Janssen. You know, they got DQ'd, their suspension, I guess, was not the right ride height.
Yeah, they brought in a minimum ride height rule for the cars, Jared. The idea, but stuff's falling apart. Is that from my van or is
okay.
that just a
from the van?
It's
from
fine.
The van.
Yeah, basically, they brought in a minimum ride height. So the lap time is good with a minimum ride height, but you end up with a damage off the jumps. So they're like, you know what, let's limit the damage, we'll set a minimum ride height. OMSC put their hands up, they're like, yeah, we made a mistake. So those two cars got DQ'd. I'm really keen. We know how good Casper is. I'd love to see Leah get a result here. She's got to keep her head and get going. You know, she's on the pace, so let's go.
All right,
let's
leave. Let's leave instead of let's go. Let's leave. We're ready to go. All right, there it is. KB forever. Leah Block, her dad, the infamous legend that is Ken Block. Lost him earlier this year. If you don't know who he is, you definitely live under a rock. The Blockhouse Racing
Legend.
Camp.
Legend.
All three of the kids racing this weekend from Micah, Kira, who's doing side-by-sides, and Leah racing in NX Next. She had a really good attitude at lunch. Had some conversation with her, and she's like, I said, dude, let's do this. It's going to be better if I can get on top of the podium.
HQ just up the road. Lucky enough to have been there. I know you have as well, Chad. Beautiful building with so much of Ken's touch on it. That amazing design feel that you had. There's an 8-care wall with loads of smashed up bits of cars on it. Leah will be wanting to bring this one home in one piece. What can she do from the front row? So Leah Block on the outside, Casper Janssen on the inside. Block has to dip the clutch a couple of times. They're off the line, but she's side by side with Casper Janssen out on the run to turn one. Ducks in behind. They both going down onto the standard lap. Three cars round onto the lead. On the standard lap behind Casper Janssen.
And Jimmy Henderson sits there in third. And those trio, that's how they ended on their previous heat, so we will see how and who comes out on top. So Casper Janssen, Leah Block, and Henderson, but again,
Henderson there into the back of Block. Into the back of Block, you saw her on the exit. I don't know if Leah was in a wrong gear or what. I thought for a second she might have had a problem, Jared, but it looks like she's okay. Interestingly, so having done a lap or two now, it's dark out the back of the circuit, much darker, and as you come in and out the lights, the contrast changes quite a lot. Good visibility through this section here, out on that, particularly now, the dirt section on the back, not quite so easy to spot your aim.
So Janssen, Block, and Henderson. Just not enough HP, not enough speed in order for them to take that gap jump. Leah Block gets a little wide, she flicks it in, gets it sideways.
I'm looking at the gap chance. So we need to be looking at Brusca. So Brusca is going to drive in the jump. The back of Leah Block. So this is when Leah's spotted. This is about when do we send her. So you want to leave her out for a couple of tidy laps and extend that gap over. So she is going standard lap again. So they come around the outside, but that's when you're done. Look at the outdoor cars that are coming, both her and Casper Janssen. Very similar trajectory. Got the car nice and sideways before the apex. She's got so much experience. ARA Rally Champion already this year, remember, in the rear-wheel drive Subaru. So yeah, she knows what she's up to with rotating the car in the corner.
Yeah, the name basically gets her in the room, and the performance keeps her in the room.
Got to do it, haven't you? She's doing it. That's what's so cool. Her and Rihanna Gelsomino, they've been flying out there on the stages.
All right, so she does need to get some ground. Casper Janssen, Henderson is nipping at her rear bumper.
But crucially, Jared, she's gapped Grzyczka by a little bit, so that gap's nearly up to 3 seconds. Now we're talking about the point at which she can go Joker. So you might send her for safety to guarantee a podium, so you could send her as soon as she's got a window on Grzyczka, you can send her. But if you do send her, you want to make sure you don't get Jimmy Henderson too many laps to try and get the hammer down. I don't think he's got much pace on her at the moment, because he's not right in the rear bumper.
But Casper Janssen.
He's looking at the inside. Great pass by Henderson, to be fair. Really tidy on the tarmac. Just nipped it in late on the brake and job done. Okay, now it's different, Jared, isn't it? When now?
Casper Janssen with just a big gap here, and Henderson now gaps Leah Block. He just was waiting for that time to strike, and he saw that opportunity. He dove in on the inside. And I believe Leah kind of maybe got a little scared, a little gun shy, and swung away from Henderson. Oh, she looks like almost got into a tire barrier.
Blue Groove coming in, isn't there, on that section now as we come towards the end of the weekend. Loads of laps on the course. Up and over the crest, trying to get over to the landing. Just slightly short. She's going really well,
Look at Janssen. I mean, just absolutely dominant. They are both on the Oldsburg's operated teams. You know, Oldsburg's kind of prepares and basically, you know, builds the vehicles, but then they have the respective teams running either absolutely aired that thing out, landing cleanly on that backside. Excuse me, that was Jimmy Anderson, right?
Yeah, huge jump, wasn't it?
Big jump by Jimmy Anderson.
Blocks almost out of the middle of that jump, just not seen by us, you can see. So just needs a tiny bit more, which is going to be a few crosses before it's going to out. So, just get into a bit, you know, how those come in. Well, then you can keep the door shut. The problem is she hasn't joked and she's got to go now. They had a window at one point of nearly 3 seconds. I might have gone there. Come out in front of Gruska, keep the door shut. She's got the door shut now. The problem is she's still got to go joke. She's staying on Gruska. She's coming down the front straight. Michaela and Gruska going out. That might help Leah out.
All right, Catherine Yancey just keeping it tiny. He is an absolute weapon. Michaela came out on top last year, but Casper Janssen won the World Next Championship. And now we're taking a look at Janssen. We're looking at the 17, Gruska. What a bringing up the rear, not part of the conversation so far. Yeah, way back there is Gordon, 17, 3 seconds. So waiting for that, last lap to hit that Yokohama Tire Joker lap. Like you said, maybe get out a little earlier. Drivers in 2 and 3.
Leah did air it out that time, just nearly as long as Henderson.
Who's that?
Gruska with a problem. Is it or is he? No, but it's Michaela. Late Michaela off to the side of the road. So that's one of the danger people they've got behind Gruska. Let's look at 1.9. Leah might just get this done. This is going to be an all-time tidy. Look, Gruska's untidy behind her. Gruska's double untidy. Leah might just jump in. Need to get on the radio and say, keep it tidy. This might just be enough. But remember, the delta's a bit different because the tunnel is a bit longer than the JoJo and we used to.
So, lap 4 of 5. Janssen, dominant. Yeah, absolutely just flexing on him right now. Henderson in second, Block in third.
Janssen as well, Jack. If you're looking for a bit of retribution after last night, you know, it sucks to win and be disqualified because you're a centimeter under ride height or whatever. Nobody wants that. We don't want that. Comes through the Joker lap tunnel. In behind will come Henderson, Leah Block will come in there as well. There he is, Gruska. Danger person for Leah. Gruska's on the inside, Leah's on the outside. So she's now got half a lap to try and find a way past. She comes in high on the banking now. Going to be tough to get onto that podium.
Nice, a lot of air between Casper Janssen, Henderson in second, Gruska in third, Block, Gordon and Michaela. Again, now coming on through.
Huge jump from Gruska. That tabletop out, but who was it earlier said they think it's the biggest jump? Tanner Bowles, yeah. He says thinks it's the biggest jump out of the course.
Yeah, that big tabletop on the back portion. Casper Janssen. A couple more turns, and you can see the brake rotors absolutely warming up. You can see them glowing here under the lights at Utah Motorsports Campus. Doubleheader weekend for Group E. Remember, the party continues in Arizona. There it is, Casper Janssen, a little squirrel before the checkered flag. Henderson gets second, and Gruska, on his debut, gets third place, that final podium spot. Leah Block just behind in fourth place. Gordon coming on in. And
Herring's such a legend, isn't he? Yeah. He shouted at me as I left the standing. He's running 3 cars in this series. Yeah. So it's great to have them back 40 motorsports along. So yeah, it always looks smart in his face.
The public square final here, and we are taking a look. And here are the official results. A runaway victory for the only international driver, Casper Janssen, representing Sweden, Jimmy Henderson in second, and Patrick Gruska from Chicago in the third spot. Leah Block in fourth, Eric Gordon and Lane Michaela in fifth. Take himself out, aired it out. But some great racing, very dominant by Casper Janssen. Let's take a look at this start here, Coley. Walk us through it.
Yeah, Leah dipped the clutch once off the line, but actually, Joe, she got away really well, because if she dipped the clutch, normally means the RPM was too low. So she's dipped it, obviously, a manual box, but she was still alongside Janssen. They got the first corner. Have Henderson behind, and I think then when Henderson snuck up the inside, that was maybe when either the confidence went or the tidiness went, and she just dropped away a little bit. Doing a great job here. I say that was the point. There was one point, it was like, one. There it was. Actually, when she braked, you saw the car. So she maybe locked one wheel on the way in, and that was enough for Henderson to get up the inside.
that quick little twitch of the wheel that allowed Henderson that opportunity to strike.
Look at Jansen's style over this jump, Jared. Almost to the landing. Yesterday he was landing on the two right wheels, rotation in the air.
That's where Vakayla went out.
Yeah, so Vakayla maybe something letting go in the back of the car, but great performance from Leah anyway. She's learning her trade here. She's a national rally champion, and we're looking forward to seeing that continue. But congratulations, Kasper Jansen. Brilliant drive.
Welcome to Stick 'em Mule.
Man, Stick 'em Mule kicks ass.
Try Stick 'em Mule. It's only a dollar.
Hello, I'm Rumble.
And I'm YouTube.
YouTube, why are you dressed like that?
Well, I've been seeing a lot of violations in the community lately, so I'm enforcing that.
You mean like people not following your policies?
Strike one!
What if someone tells the truth, but it's labeled as misinformation?
Strike two!
Wow, what if I want to ask questions and have different opinions on things?
Strike three! You're out of here!
This thing is a monster. The numbers do not lie.
The reality series did 15 million views, and that's in 12 weeks.
Power Slap has certainly been garnering attention all over the world, but social media is where it's taken off like a rocket ship.
We put on the highest quality productions.
The first ever live Power Slap event presented by Rumble.
Did the right promotion.
So many great storylines.
People learn their backgrounds, and they're a fan of them as people.
So everything about this is going to go to the next level.
Power Slap.
This sport has only existed a few months. Imagine what we'll do over the next few years.
Sticker Mule is the fastest and easiest way to order custom stickers. It only takes a few seconds to order, and every purchase comes with a free online proof, free shipping, and blazing fast turnaround. Each sticker is made with a durable weatherproof vinyl that is suitable for indoor or outdoor use. Die-cut stickers are also available in familiar shapes, including circles, rectangles, squares, ovals, and rounded corner stickers. Try 10 custom stickers for $1 plus free shipping.
Hey, YouTube, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm updating my content policies.
Really? Do you mind if I take a look?
Sure. Yeah. Here you go. Oh, wait. One more. This is a new one.
Thank you. I'll block off my schedule.
It's a real page turner. Page 94 is my personal favorite.
Okay. Can't wait. Honestly, YouTube, this is too much to read.
Joining us here in the box is our most recent winner, Kasper Jansen. Big smile on his face. Congratulations, man. I saw you looking at your times. You happy?
Yeah, it's quite good. It was the fastest time of the weekend, so that's good.
Lap time or overall time? What are you looking at?
Oh, lap time.
Lap time, yeah, okay, good. So you're stoked?
Yeah.
Okay, another big grin. It's so good, isn't it?
Yeah, just
so good.
How old are you again?
18.
18, okay, yeah. Hey, let's take a look at this again. Windows of opportunity, you made it look really easy. You're out front, breakaway, you took the Joker on the last lap. That was the technique that you utilized. Is that how you initially planned it?
Yeah, actually, it was how we planned it. Just no mistake, all lap, and it's good driving all the way, so that's fine.
We love your style over the tabletop. When you come over the tabletop, you got a nice bit of rotation on, you're sort of two wheels down the right-hand side. You've nailed that.
Yeah, that's a really fun jump. So
yeah,
we have to fly over and turn down in the jump, so that's really, really fun.
What's the trickiest part in these?
Maybe under the jump, there's triggers. And the first corner was even really fun, and this one was the funnest part of the track.
That big tabletop?
Yeah, and the left corner.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that, I mean, Tanner said, so is that the signature move? Is that his move? Or what?
Well, it is now. We have to call that the Casper, aren't we? The Casper slide or something.
It's the Casper checkered. Yeah. He does a little shimmy.
Yeah.
The Casper shimmy right before he crosses the finish line. Dude, congratulations, man. Some great racing here.
I'll hit you up to your ledge. Well done.
Yeah. Leah Block, a lot of eyeballs on her. She's right there. Just these little nuances. And I know you guys are teammates. What do you think of Leah?
It's pretty fast for the first time in the car last race, so that's really impressive. So it's good.
Awesome. Well, thank you again. Congratulations, Casper. And all right, so again, Casper, our winner. And here is what's looking and what's coming down the chute here. Group E final. Kevin Erickson, Andreas Backrud, Tanner Faust, and Robin Larson, Fraser McConnell, Ollie Erickson, and then Ollie Bennett and Connor Martell.
Who do you like for the win? What's your money on?
Kevin.
Yeah?
Yeah, all the way.
Okay, there we go. Could that be because you're in the same team?
All right.
Probably.
Well, we'll let you go. Thank you so much, Casper. Thank you. Side by side. Side by side is up next. And this is our side by side final. We are taking a look. We have a star-studded cast and a talented cast, 10 racers. And Coley, right before you came here, there's a lot of smack talking between Travis, Cletus McFarland. We're talking about TR, Gray Ledbetter, the sort. They were talking.
Amanda was here as well.
Well, Amanda's not racing. Amanda's not racing because Brandon is.
Okay,
They're sharing
the car this weekend.
So here is our front row. Kanan Baker, who won last night. Can he do it again? Tyler Emery, TR was talking a lot of smack. Gray Ledbetter, she was. Cletus McFarland, Brandon Sorensen, Cowboy Cerrone, Terry Madden, and Kira Block.
So Travis didn't make it?
No, they are. There's a fifth row. Travis Pastrana and Leticia Bacani
there they are.
That back row.
There they are. We ran out of graphics.
The big one is that Travis says he can beat Cletus even though he's behind him.
Okay.
So that is where they got money running on this. And, you know, Travis loves betting just a dollar, not a lot of money. It's awesome. I'll bet you a dollar. And you know what? He pays his bets. Here we go. Our side-by-side final. Who's going to get the whole shot again on that front row? You got TR and Kanan Baker, who got the win last night. Diving in.
He's Ramarine. I think you got it.
143 or the 20. 21 to 82. 71. So it looks like Tyler Ramarine.
Yeah.
TR gets that whole shot. Baker, McFarland, Ledbetter, and Sorensen. Look at that. Seven of them take the standard.
I'm looking to see. So Travis has been what, just a buck again? Yeah. Remember, he lost $500 last game. Only been small bets. I bet he regretted that one, didn't he?
Woo, getting in a tussle with that wall. So Cowboy Cerrone, Kira Block, and TP Travis Pastrana taking the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. Five laps in total. Again, the most laps. You can see the long travel suspension just eating that back tabletop.
Kind of Baker look has dropped right
red
down.
Flag.
Got red flags. So I wonder if something's happened.
Somebody
to
might have
Baker.
Flipped.
Because he was right. He was in the mix, Jared, and then has disappeared. So he fell down the leaderboard. So
not seeing where he's at. Maybe flipped. Again, these guys. All right, so it is. Wow, that's a big hit. Our winner from last night.
All three rounds this year.
Yeah,
all
that's right. Yeah,
this
thank
year.
You for reminding me.
Yeah, he's done so well. 15 years old, I think he said last night, didn't he? Super good driver. I think sometimes we think it's easy. When they win that much, Chad, it's easy. The reason he's winning that much is he's right on the edge all the while. You know, he's just getting that ultimate lap time the whole time. And when you do that, occasionally you have a little problem and you go over. So that's a shame, but most importantly, he's okay. It's fine.
Absolutely.
We'll clear that up. And I don't think he'd be allowed to restart. There's a new regulation. You cause the red flag. You can't take the restart. So even if the car's okay, I don't think he'd be back on the road.
Wow. Dwindled down to 9 cars. We'll clarify that with the officials. There's Ollie Erickson. You can see that hood strapped up. That thing was the official race tape there, keeping that thing solidly down.
How was the second LCQ? Oh, I watched some of it out. Fraz won, didn't they?
Yeah, Fraz
won. The atmosphere out the front was insane, dude. It was so good.
Sure.
I kind of want to move the booth down in front of the stands because it was the noise was brilliant.
Electric. Thank you so much for all the fans that are here in the building or watching live around the world. Jared Deanda, Andrew Cooley, your tour guides here. We're down in the pits, and it's really cool electricity over here because we get all the drivers and the cars whizzing by, humming by. Go, Kira,
oh,
go.
So
hey,
cool.
There we go.
They were down early.
Oh, there's Micah. Yeah. There's Micah, the brother, Andreas.
He came up to you guys. Dude, I thought you were going to win. I thought I wouldn't go out first key. He goes, oh, no, really? Why? I was like, I think because it was $500. Like, yeah, it's exactly. So funny.
Okay, so here, let's see.
Oh, wow, he went
for the tires. No, he went to that tire wall.
Yeah, but he went for the jump pass on the inside of Remory's and then clipped the that's yep. That caught.
Bold
great.
Move. Bold yeah. Move, Cotton. You can block a tire, you can block a ball. Hey, starting young. How we doing?
Yeah, in France, every kid's got Jamaican flag. It's definitely must be out there handing them out.
All right, let's re-rack them, stack them, and track them. Getting them set.
Restart?
We will find out. That could be, again, like you said, the winner of the first three rounds, double headers in Oklahoma now. The winner last night.
Look at the steering. Steering's not right. Oh, they're saying he will restart. I thought Rick said that he could have. By the way, he's got massive toe out on that Jared. That means the front wheels are pointing outwards rather than in. And that is not going to handle it. It's understeering like a pig through the long tarmac corners.
I don't know.
I think he'll have a go because you might as well wait for some attrition. I mean, you know, I was kind of hoping a few more people would retire, but.
Yeah, that's a lot of vehicles. You know, 10, yeah. That's the most, you know, we'll see here the entirety of this weekend. You know, we get 8 vehicles in total for. Yeah, it's great.
Come on down to an event if you haven't been to one before. Broken steering, 21 down. Okay, yep. Well, yeah, we kind of figured.
Yeah, that's. I think that's a smart decision. You know, don't want to risk, obviously, you know, any danger to him. So, yeah, join us. You know, we have future rounds. If, you know, we want to create the FOMO, baby. Come on, fear of missing out. You want to see this thing live. You know, cruise through the pits, complimentary access to the pits with price of admission, or watch live for free. Download the app Rumble and watch every round of Nitro Cross and all the things. Coley, do you think you're going to continue racing the Van Prix at future rounds?
I'm not going to lie, I was extremely nervous before I went out to do it. Like,
I honestly could tell.
Slight lack of safety
I could tell.
In the car.
Yeah.
I did have a really good time. I think you could get, the trouble is, you get a race sitting the lid on, you get all carried away, and you want to go as quick as you can. So there's a bit of things, you know what? The person was stuck in first gear was maybe a nice limiting factor. Because you were still getting air even in first gear. I think if I'd had second, third, fourth, I would have wanted to get stuck in, but it was. It's good fun, and that is what it is the spirit of Nitro Circus.
There's Stephanie and Uncle Saul.
Yeah,
how
are
we doing?
Yes,
a lot of Jamaican flags flying now.
But yeah, it's that spirit. It's the Nitro Circus Van Prix, isn't it? We've had the Nitro Circus show. It's that spirit of fun and getting out there and getting amongst it. So yeah, it was good fun, man. It was really good fun. How many Jamaican flags do you think? Bigger. Yes, look at that shirt. Now we're talking. I see some great shirts. You see the snacker and shirt with the 13 on the back and all the different snacks on it.
I did see our boy Butchie flying the Andreas Backroot and the Ken Block flag. So Butchie, shout out to Butchie for bringing those flags. All right, so re-rack them, but we are sans that of Kanan Baker. So that front row is only one vehicle. Look at that smile. That is a very big contrast from what we saw earlier today here in the family room.
Back in the room. Good performance in that second RTQ. Shocker, wasn't it, to see both of the Mont Sports cars not make it?
Yeah, Connor Martel and Travis not in the finals.
Both the XI cars in. It's a complete swap.
No. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, complete swap, isn't it, from yesterday?
We take 3 from there and then 2 from there, yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, so who did go in?
I can't remember. My mind's like an etch-a-sketch, man. I draw a lot of pictures and then I just shake it up.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. 9 vehicles, NITRO, let's go. On that front row, we got the TR, Tyler Remorade, Gray Ledbetter, Cletus McFarland on that second row as well. You can see Cletus dropping into formation. Going for, again, looks like the standard lap.
I was looking at Travis, so Cletus up into P3, might lose a position here. That's Brandon Sorensen with the red car, the one that Matt was driving yesterday. Terry Madden in the Gel Blast delivery. Where's Travis? He got a bad start. 2051 for 9 big time.
Bad luck here today, but Remorade out front, Ledbetter, Sorensen, McFarland, Madden, and Bafani.
He went Joe Kirby, he's had a little bit of contact there, so Travis was looking to get past Kira Block there and just almost got into the side of her and half over rotated in the banking. So Travis a long way off the back now, going to be tough to get back to McFarland. He's going to lose a dollar.
You know, I mean, there's still a lot of racing left to do. And we saw how quickly, you know, last night's winner could get into it. And who is that?
As Kira's gone round. So Travis was, Travis blessed him. Kira, he was quicker, but he couldn't find a way through. And he's never going to take Kira out. You know, he's so lovely to the family. So he's now been released. But Travis, we now need to see Pastrana start. You know, we need to see Sandy McSenderson. He's got to get out there and try and close down that gap. And now get onto the back of the pack. Here he is, the back to the 199 in over the jump.
Somebody came to a halt. I mean, gosh, River Reed could lap him. I feel like he's so far out there, he's almost a lapper. Obviously, he's not going to, but he just has some serious distance on the rest of the pack.
12.5.
That's crazy. 12.5 seconds. River Reed, so masterclass racing. Good line. He does have to hit the Joker lap here, so he's obviously going to lose a little bit of that. So again, it does adjust, but then once he does come out of that tunnel, you see where the ring lands. The big battle here is for that last podium position. And there it goes. Remory comes out blazing.
Look in the background. So you'll see Travis Pastrana.
No, you can't.
No, okay, that's a good point. Yeah. Yeah,
there they are.
There they are. Behind him, look at the battle here.
The battle for third, it's Cerrone and Sorensen. So Cowboy and Sorensen going for it. The 19-year-old of Brandon Sorensen and Cerrone. Cowboy, UFC Hall of Famer, but Remory dominant out front.
He's running third. Sorensen third. So did he do that? I couldn't see the joint was coming. Two side-by-sides, side-by-sides, about 8 feet in the air. Epic racing from them. I'm sorry.
Cowboy. And here it is. Remory gets the checkered flag. You can see the fist pumping in the cockpit. Remory. And we thought Pastrana was out early on. He fought back. And Travis Pastrana gets second place.
Bafani.
She's a pro skateboarder. She's doing a 50-50
grind. Yeah, man.
Leticia. Okay, well, again,
she's
podium. Remory, Pastrana, and Sorensen. Ledbetter fourth. Cowboy Cerrone.
There's a roll in the background as well, Jared.
That's Cowboy Cerrone.
Oh, no. Oh,
we lost the
wheels off. It's Cowboy Cerrone was in P3, looking like a podium, and unfortunately, as Bucky Lasse once said, it's an odium.
No.
So it hasn't worked out. We've got Leticia Bafani parked up on the tyre barriers.
Oh, man.
She rolled yesterday. She's been in the wars.
Clean up on all the aisles here. and not just on aisle one. And there it is, Kira Block coming on in. Kira Block.
Kira had
car
a half
number
spin.
13.
Yeah, she had a half spin, didn't she, earlier on in the race?
Leticia high-centered there on some Yokohama tire barriers. So unfortunate for her. Again, Cowboy Cerrone, he is sans a wheel. So some crazy racing. Congratulations, Tyler Remory, Travis Pastrana, and Brandon Sorensen.
Shout out for the side-by-side, because that was serious racing. Like, they've really put it all on the line there. They were going for it. That battle on the last act was brilliant.
It felt like a shell game.
Yeah.
You know, where's the ball? Who's gonna get the gold? Tyler Remory comes out on top. Pastrana fought back for second, and Brandon Sorensen in his first Nitro Cross race gets third place. Congratulations to 1, 2, and 3. Ledbetter, Matt, and Kira Block, Cowboy Cerrone, Leticia Bafani, Cletus McFarland, and Kanan Baker. So, some exciting racing going on, and one more race, and that is Group E. So let's throw it down. It's my homegirl. Where are you at? Anna, where are you at?
Homegirls down here. We are pre-grid right now. I'm standing right here next to Kevin Erickson. Kevin, you got second last night. Top qualifier today. Won your races. Now here we are at the main event. I could see you. You're shaking. What's the anticipation here?
Yeah, I just want to get out there. The weight is not so fun, so I just hope we go green soon and get those four laps, and hopefully they go my way.
Any specific strategy? What is it going to take for you to get your first win of 2023?
I mean, you need to be the fastest out there, but it's tricky. I mean, it's such a tight field. You have to be smart. One mistake and you're done. So, hopefully I can get out in front, and then it's just about the risk of doing mistakes, but also you can't get caught up. So it's a balance.
All right, good luck to you, Kevin. Let's go see who else we can find. One of the loveliest personalities here, Andreas Backerud. Andreas, here you are, you're second in positioning. What is it going to take for you tonight to get the win?
Well, I need a whole shot off the line. But I have Ken Butch up here, my previous tech engineer at the Hunian Racing Division, waving the flag. Loads of fans, my family up here. It's awesome to be here in Salt Lake. It's going to be a hard final and going to be crucial to win that start.
All right, good luck to you, Andreas. Fraser McConnell, Unfortunately, last night you did not make the main event. Here you are tonight. You got it in. What is it going to take for you to get up on the box? We are so excited to see you here tonight.
Well, you know, first of all, big up all the fans, but this is going to be an all or nothing final. It's been a tough weekend, to say the least, trying to get me out, trying to get me down, but they're going to have to do a lot more than that to get me on the fight. So I'm going to be flying this black, green, and gold car to the top, full send. You know the vibes. Big up.
Your mom and you have decorated the pits, the paddock, with Jamaican flags. Fly them very strong. Is everyone from Jamaica back at home watching you?
Most definitely. You know, they're tuning into Rumble, and you know, the support from back home and the support I have here is, you know, second to none. So I'm doing it for them today.
All righty. Thank you so much, Frazier. We are going to head to a break. I'm going to take it away, guys.
Welcome to Stick'em Yo.
Man, Stick'em-Yule kicks ass.
Try Stick'em-Yule. It's only a dollar.
Hello, I'm Rumble.
And I'm YouTube.
YouTube, why are you dressed like that?
Well, I've been seeing a lot of violations in the community lately, so I'm enforcing that.
You mean like people not following your policies?
Strike one!
What if someone tells the truth, but it's labeled as misinformation?
Strike two!
Wow, what if I want to ask questions and have different opinions on things?
Strike three, you're out of here!
This thing is a monster. The numbers do not lie.
The reality series did 15 million views, and that's in 12 weeks.
Slap has certainly been garnering attention all over the world, but social media is where it's taken off like a rocket ship.
We put on the highest quality productions.
The first ever live Power Slap event presented by Rumble.
Did the right promotion.
So many great storylines.
People learn their backgrounds, and they're a fan of them as people.
So everything about this is going to go to the next level.
Power Slap.
This sport has only existed a few months. Imagine what we'll do over the next few years.
Sticker Mule is the fastest and easiest way to order custom stickers. It only takes a few seconds to order, and every purchase comes with a free online proof, free shipping, and blazing fast turnaround. Each sticker is made with a durable weatherproof vinyl that is suitable for indoor or outdoor use. Die-cut stickers are also available in familiar shapes, including circles, rectangles, squares, ovals, and rounded corner stickers. Try 10 custom stickers for $1 plus free shipping.
Hey YouTube, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm updating my content policies.
Really? Do you mind if I take a look?
Sure. Yeah. Here you go. Oh wait. One more. This is a new one.
Thank you. I'll block off my schedule.
It's a real page turner. Oh, page 94 is my personal favorite.
Okay, can't wait. Honestly, YouTube, this is too much to read.
The sun is set, the lights are on, and the cars are powered up. That's right, these 1,000 horsepower, all electric FC1Xs, 8 of them to be exact, are ready to do battle here at Utah Motorsports Campus. Day 2 of this doubleheader weekend. Jared Deanda, Andrew Coley, Diana Dahlgren, your tour guides on this party train that is Nitro Cross. Join us, most recent winner, Tyler Ramirez, dude. Congratulations, doggy. He said, I wanted this so freaking bad. I said, you're not even sweating. He said, oh, believe me, I'm sweating. Why here? Why now? Why?
Yeah,
why?
I mean, Kanan's been pushing me every race, but I've gotten second place 3 races in a row, and I've been working my butt off, and I wanted it so bad going into today's final.
You pulled up here. Who hugged you first? I saw a little girl.
That was like my little cousin that came up and hugged me. She was the first one came running. So
that's cool, awesome, man. I saw you pound your roof. Great racing. I'll tell you what, everything behind you, I mean, at one point you had a 12 and a half second lead. Then you hit that joker. But did you know, was your spotter in your ear saying, bro, there is calamity behind you. Just keep racing.
Well, at first he's like, oh, 3 to 4 car lengths. And I'm like, okay, let's make it more. And I just kept pushing every lap. And then at some points I would hit a turn and I saw nobody behind me. But in my mind, I had someone right behind me and I wanted to keep pushing every lap. And that last lap, he said, hey man, you know, you haven't got anybody for a while. Why don't you just back off a little bit? And that's when I kind of started to soak it in a little bit. Take awesome. The huge crowd, man, it was so awesome.
And you know what's really crazy is, I mean, you and Kanan Baker right out of that gate, you guys almost got into it. He took himself out, almost took you guys out, going up and over that hip. It was almost over before it began.
Yeah, that's unfortunate, you know.
Right here. That was the Brandon Sorensen pass, starting to draft on Cowboys, throwing him in the air. That was seriously brave, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's unfortunate Kanan got out first lap, you know. It would have been a hell of a show. I was willing to go toe-to-toe with him till the end, but you know, we kind of jumped over that thing and
look at this thing.
Oh yeah,
how's it feel seeing it back?
That was just dude, I've been fighting for that all day.
Yeah, man, that was awesome, dude. You deserved it, man. Oh. You had really good racecraft. This 1.4-mile track, a lot of asphalt, a lot of dirt, very different from Oklahoma. You know, we're looking forward to it. Are we gonna see you in Arizona?
Yeah. We're for sure going to be here for the rest of the season. This is great seat time for us. You know, we got a pretty busy schedule, but we're going to be here for the rest of the year.
Awesome. Thank you so much, brother. Time to celebrate.
Thank
get
you, guys.
Get your trophy, get you some medals.
Well done.
There
Thank
it is. Tyler Remmerid, your winner here.
Let's go.
K2 at Nitro Cross side by side. Thank you so much. All right, so again, we're getting prepared for the Group E. We're talking about, you know, the Joker, what's going down, how many laps. I believe we're going to see 4 laps. My man Micah Kranz down there, Jimmy Coleman, they've been partying down there in the pits. We had Nitro Circus. There's a... There we got Butchie there with the Andreas Backerud back in the blue flag there. But again, Yokohama Tire, Joker lap, that is, again, the standard lap is the big gap, the pass through, the tabletop. That is, again, so again, we're getting ready. This is Nitro Cross Group E finale.
The Yokohama Joker lap is used in Nitro Cross to be able to help someone that gets a poor start or that qualifies bad to be able to really have a free track at some point where they're not always in traffic. So you see a lot of the people in the back of the pack taking the Joker lap the first lap, especially if the Joker lap's longer. Now, it's really unique because sometimes it's longer, sometimes it's shorter. Your spotter and the driver always has to figure out exactly what they need based on the drivers around them and how much that you will gain or lose in the Joker for how you come back, what we call the zipper.
New to the broadcast this year is the Yokohama Joker Predictor Graphic. This is going to give you a little more insight on who's going to come out of the Joker ahead. The Joker lap is always a little bit longer than standard Nitro Rallycross track. And the rule is, you have to take it once in every race.
It gets crazy, and that is your Yokohama Joker.
Finals, that's right. Day 2 of this doubleheader weekend. We got Arizona next, we got Calgary. Guess what? We are gonna have one heck of a season and these things are just kicking off. We're taking a look at Kevin Erickson leading the points, Pastrana, Backerud, 1, 2, and 3. And these drivers are fighting tooth and nail. I mean, this, the future is now. These FC1X vehicles, you know, many stories have unfolded between drivers, pits, crews, you know, obviously the Block family playing a major role here. All 3 of the kids racing out here. For the story of the day, qualifiers, Backerud, Ollie, Kevin Erickson, TQ, Kevin Erickson, so he gets that pole position, he fights back. You know, yesterday we saw neither of the Excite vehicles, and guess what, today we're not seeing either of these drivers, Vermont Sports Car. So a very unfortunate turn of events here for Vermont Sports Car, but going again, From hero to, I'll just say it, you know, I've got a great sensationalism, from hero to zero.
Thanks, buddy.
I had to say it, dude, again.
Yeah, I had a lucky horseshoe shoved so far somewhere yesterday, and it fell out this morning. We couldn't catch a break.
Did you hear that ring? It just fell out.
Yeah, no, it fell out this morning.
I know. Hey, good job racing side by side. Yeah, I thought you were out, man.
I was, so I, Cletus took the vehicle that I was going to be running, the top liner vehicle. There was two top liner vehicles, and they took each other out. They both rolled in front of me. But Cletus goes, look, I think they'd get your, it was basically a display model that was sitting there, and we couldn't get it running. There was something, it was there because it wasn't running. So they kept trying all day long. And at the end of the day, Cletus convinced me to get back out there. He said, I don't care. You got to get out there. And if you can't beat me, I'm going to, if you beat me, I'm going to streak the front of everything. That was a horrible idea, but let's see it.
That would have been awesome.
All right, that was side by side. Let's put that to bed. Congratulations, second place. Good racing out there.
Thanks, first.
No. I mean, wait, whatever. It's all good. Great win last night. Yeah, okay?
Thank you.
So a racer that's on the front row, Andreas Backrud. I know he's got a lot of fans. The Backrud Blue, even his daughter is here in the building cheering him on. Let's take a closer look at a deeper dive on Andreas Backrud.
A fan favorite around the paddock, Backrud is a man who does things in twos. Two event wins last year.
Backrud, the European Rallycross champion, is going to take first victory in Nitro Rallycross.
Andreas Backrud gets the win.
Backrud, look, he's stoked.
And two massive crashes.
Sideways, Backrud rolls, enormous crash. Andreas Backrud, end over end. That's going to be a red flag 100%.
In his honor, let's get a second angle on that massive hit.
There he is.
It's Andreas Backrud.
He has a few tricks up his sleeve. Having worked for rallycross heavyweight Petter Solberg and driven alongside the late, great Ken Block. Though, when it comes to nitrocross, he's always been the bridesmaid, never the bride, coming second in last year's championship. Buoyed up by his fan base, the Backrud Blue, can the affable Norwegian convert smiles into wins and take the championship by storm?
There we are in the cockpit of Backrud. Travis, you just had some words to me. You said, what about Backrud?
He's been the fastest all week. He is definitely the guy to beat out here, but he has been petrified of the jumps the last couple months since those two big crashes. This FC1X is extremely fast, and it's deceiving because you can't hear it. So when you're in the car, it is one of the scariest vehicles you will ever drive. It's the scariest track you'll ever drive. And although he is the fastest, when it got pushed three wide, Larson jumped, Ericsson jumped, and Backrud shut it down, which kind of shut him down from being, you know, P1 to way back yesterday in the finals. Yeah. Or, well, you know, P3 at the end. But
no, exactly. Yeah, I know exactly what you meant. But hey, he's got his daughter here in the building. That's got to be some extra motivation. You know how it is being a father, you know, being a daughter, you know, a girl dad, you know how it is. And like, so I feel that's got to be an extra vote of confidence for him.
It does. I feel like him coming in as a father now, he has this new responsibility. He is, I believe, the most talented driver out on the field. But the fear sets in. These cars are fast. These jumps are big. And being a father, I don't know if that's going to help or hurt.
Oh, okay, you tell us then. You're one of the craziest guys I've ever met. You got three kids, I think. And I, so when you became a dad,
I think, hopefully.
Is it two?
Two. I got two.
Two kids. So did you find becoming a dad? Did you have to take a different approach?
Tanner. No, for me, I just Tanner's been on.
Tanner's in it.
But no, I mean, being a father, I think, put things in perspective, but also wanted me to show them how hard you work,
yep,
that you can accomplish your dreams for sure.
Absolutely. Tanner Faust in the cockpit, getting ready. He's in it. Remember, Tanner, you know, the side vehicles, they weren't in it. And now here you guys, roll reversal, absolute reverse from the front to the back.
But you look at, you look at Frazier yesterday, not qualifying after being really up there. Tanner, so awesome all day long. Right. Anyone can go first to last, as I've proved today.
And you have a great attitude. I know you. I know deep down you're just like, but you have a great attitude, man. So I appreciate it.
And look at Kevin Erickson, the pass of the lifetime. He has a knack for going backwards into corners and just, I mean,
did you see the inside one? Did you see the inside pass? Because he's always going about outside. He had an inside pass that was unbelievable. So he can do it all. Casper Janssen saying all his money's on Kevin Erickson. He won there in next. All right, here's our grid for our Group E final, brought to you by Public Square. Kevin Erickson and Andreas Backrud in the front row. Tanner Faust and Robin Larson on that second row. Third row, Fraser McConnell, DRR, and the OMSC driver, Oliver Erickson. Final row, Excite Energy, Ollie Bennett, and finally, Connor Martell, your Vermont sports car teammate.
Connor Bennett, yesterday, he was on fire, P1. Honestly, I don't think anyone would have touched him today. Had some bad luck, didn't quite get it. Kevin got him in the heat. But man, you know, I'd like to see Tanner get in there. He was more aggressive than I've ever seen him. He's back, he's on fire, yep. And it was a shame yesterday.
Yeah, he seems really cool and calm. He's excited. Cole, you want to call it? Do the honors.
That's yeah, man, let's go.
Go and send it. Tanner fast in the cockpit. Look at the race face. It is on and cracking. NITRO, let's go and send it. Nitrocross.
Pastrana from row two. Great launch shots there from, on the front from last it was, I think. Moves across the inside line immediately. Shuts the door. Backward goes the long way around the outside line. Backward just ahead of Ericsson. Ericsson, though, now trying to dive up the inside of him. Ericsson does get backward. They're heading up to the big gap jump now. So Ericsson leading on the big gap jump on the standard lap and going into
so
the choke. It's backward, I think.
The choker line was watered very heavily. Wow. But they still come out in the range.
Oh, the zipper! Look at that. It's back in and in. Who's that, the number four?
No, Larson's a genius. He's absolutely, I mean, he always figures out a way, no matter where he is, to come out ahead. If you look at Larson right now, he's sitting fourth, but he is probably close enough that he is almost P1 right now.
Right, yeah. No, I mean, he slid right into the zipper. Masterclass slipped right into that fourth.
Martel up into P5 already from P8 on the grid. That's a great performance by him. Really impressive. Ericsson trying to gather that front. He's got 0.8 already over Andreas Backwood. Watch for Larson, though. He's only 2.0 back already. Say, what do you reckon it is at the minute, the delta?
Delta's 1.8. But honestly, it was looked really, really slick. There's a couple spots that have just been hard to keep.
Oh! Ollie Ericsson.
Ollie Ericsson shuts it down. Ollie Ericsson dead in the water out there. That is a huge blow sitting in third place.
Happened yesterday as well, Jared, if you remember, after the contact in the first quarter. So Ollie Ericsson can't catch a break in the finals.
Larson gets lucky all the time. It is not luck anymore. Up to Pete, and the only one to take the Joker. Kevin is super smooth, and honestly, Backer's been the fastest all week, but you can't count Larson out. He's a champion for a reason.
All right, here we go. So Kevin Ericsson out front, Andreas Backer. He's fine. Larson, Faust, McConnell, Bennett, all taking that Joker lap. Talking about this Delta. Travis talking about how slick it is and how dangerous that could be, how tidy you need to keep it.
Unless you're Kevin Ericsson, in which case he gets back in from two football fields away.
He's doing that on the iPad.
There it is. Even on that, just the attitude of the vehicle. He's thrown up more gravel machine gun than anybody in that sweeper right there.
Both Ericssons find a way to bat the cars. They will still get the drive off the corner. It's absolutely amazing to watch.
Larson is only 1.4 from back to his teammate Backer. I think Ericsson's just edging away here. So Ericsson's now got 2.5 over Robin Larson. Remember, Larson is the leading driver to have taken that alternate Joker lap. There you can see the gap look between the front two, 1.1. But Larson, look, he's all over the back of Backer already.
How is a dude Backer's been the fastest all week? I don't know what's going on. If it's slick, if you see him chasing that table tap out of the corner, there must have been something to change on the track.
Travis, there's a point here, surely, which I was going to say, maybe they sent Backer in to try and give Larson a bit of space to close down on the gap to Ericsson, but I don't think Larson's quite there, is he?
I have to tell you, there's probably no team tactics that ever get played. Even if they say it, you just take the radio, turn it down, and you just keep driving your own
car. What? You're breaking up. Okay, I got to go.
So some of the drivers going over this,
nice shot.
And some going over with the button. As the race comes on, you'll see the people just let go of the button and setting it to flat. Look at just backing it in. I love that corner. So
Tanner Faust was coming in super hot. Sandra is a lovely job.
The Yokohama Tire Joker Lab is saying that Kevin Ericsson will retain first, but that's all I consider.
Lies.
Robin Larson.
Look at
again.
Him drive. That corner is so slick.
Whipping that thing.
Licking it.
I love his style. Faust simmering in the back. Oh, no. McConnell side. Oh. The wall. Fraser McConnell.
A big hit.
Oh, has he broken the steering? McConnell's playing with the back. He's so coming on to the last lap, then just one lap left to go. Ericsson and Backer will have the Joker this time round. At the minute, the delta is only 1.7 from Ericsson back to Larson.
The Yokohama Joker might be
enough to get him. Travis Pastrana clapping his hands together here. This is going to be super close. This could be for the win.
Okay. But hey, you got to think. Here we go. Ericsson's going to be coming in from the right, the inside. He always comes in from the outside.
Wait.
Overshoots the corner.
I think Backer's missed the
Backer
Joker.
Missed
no.
The Joker.
Oh, it's the final lap? Oh, no.
Yeah. Backer missed
well,
the Joker.
Backer's said Backer is not joking. Kevin Ericsson has. Andreas Backer
oh, that's
is
a huge
get
blow. Yeah.
And he's holding up his teammate. That's like reverse
and,
team
oh,
tactics.
No. And here we go. And Robin Larson does get in that position. We're going to have to see if it's incorrect. But it's saying that Backer has not taken his Yokohama Tire Joker lap. And that would not get back. This is the final lap. Four laps of both laps you see. Backer's camp and in his cabin.
I don't even know what to say. I've never seen a winner that did win. What?
Wow. He was going to know when he sees
total
the checkered
mental
flag.
Lapse.
He's going to be so disappointed when he sees the checkered flag, Jared. That's when you realize what's happened. Normally, you get a signal. He runs his car. Don't forget, the finals are often longer than four laps, and this is a big mistake.
So, as Robin Larson is officially, because again, look at that, the exclamation mark, he missed it. So, Larson essentially has first, Erickson in second, Tanner Faust, in third. And here it is, coming in, Baccarat first, but didn't take the Joker. So, unofficially, Larson, Erickson, and Faust.
Four, five.
And there it is, Frazier McConnell, Ollie Bennett, Connor Martell, Ollie Erickson was out. So, again, unofficially, Larson will have the win by just a skosh. Wow, what a crazy turn of events. There is, we're in the cockpit of Baccarat.
I haven't seen this since Dave Mira did this at X Games.
Wow. There is Larson, and there they are, as you said, teammates holding him up. He did get in front of Kevin Erickson, both of his DRR vehicles.
If he didn't get in front of Kevin on that last one, there would have been a big fight on with rivalries there.
Wow.
Sorry, I can't even talk. I'm
no, that, I mean, just such a lot. Oh.
That's, yeah, that's frustrating.
And there it is in the cockpit.
I don't think.
Oh, no. Andreas is absolutely gutted. He slams the car door and walks away through the scrutineering tent. He is gutted, and I understand that. You put the hard work in, Travis, you come across the line. You know, I think he could potentially have lost it anyway to Larson in terms of pace, obviously.
But he still might have had third.
It would have been a podium. It would have been championship points. You know, this could be a. It could be.
This goes all the way to second penalty.
It's only going back to fourth. He only dropped one, maybe two positions. But the highs of highs, look at that. There we go. That's family. But he doesn't want to be talking to anyone right now. That's frustrating.
Yeah, that's frustrating. Let's focus on Larson. Let's let Andreas chill out. Larson, again, the frustration, you can see it. It's palpable.
It's palpable.
Larson will be your winner. Is DRR
Focus on Robin Larson going from way in the back. This is, no, it's there.
And there it is. Robin Larson in the cockpit.
Here, like, this was flat out earned. He did.
Oh, absolutely.
He was a genius diving. I mean, no one thought he was going to dive in that first lap. Took the Joker, got into third ahead of Connor.
Into fourth, yeah, slid into fourth. That was sick, yeah.
Sorry.
No, I know, exactly. But no, I mean, just that spot was created just for him. And then there it is once again on that Joker lap. Boom, slides in front of Kevin Erickson, which gives him the lead.
Well, let's talk about Tanner Faust as well. He's been out of the series for so long. I think this is the first time he's been in FC1X.
Yes. No, well, he had a Race of Champions
for
30
that's
seconds.
That doesn't count.
30 seconds.
No, but Tanner has been doing extreme. He's been doing everything, and Tanner is absolutely, he came in here with a mission.
Yes.
He has something to prove, and I haven't seen him be that aggressive in years. I'm so proud of Tanner.
Yep. Yeah, Tanner Faust, an absolute legend, has won them all in the Rallycross sanctioning bodies. I mean, he's done it from Europe to America, across the pond here on North America soil. And Robin Larson, you know, he's your defending Nitrocross champion and just hasn't struck gold just yet. And here he is doing it for DRR.
Larson always takes what's available, and he will do the best of his capabilities in every single event. He's like Scott Speed always said, he makes good decisions. Top to bottom, he takes whatever he can get, and he always ends up near the front of that pack.
Sees the opportunity, he strikes when he knows he needs to. Really good racecraft. Andrew Cole, he's gonna jump over there and have some words with him.
Well, yeah, and McConnell, he got, you know, even after hitting that wall, I've never seen anyone be able to jump so much. It was full Ken Block style. The car is crab walking sideways, and he's launching the big gap. And then, of course, you have Connor Martell, man. Such a heartbreaking day for him yesterday.
Yep.
Yes, and then Ollie Bennett. Erickson, man, Ollie. It's something about the Ollies. They've been at Martell. They've been having such bad luck, and they are so fast.
Yep, yes. It's just a crazy turn of events here. Again, congratulations to you, Travis, for getting the win last night, and then just, you know, here you are in the booth. Love the feedback. I love your enthusiasm for the sport, and I think that's what's great.
This is an amazing sport, and we have a lot of work to do, but it's so cool to see these guys. Everyone's scared to death to hit that jump, and they all, you know, they all step up, and they'll say, you know what, I want to be here. I want to challenge myself. I want to see this next level cars, and I'm going to let the winners take this from here, but it has been an honor. Thank you for coming.
Always a pleasure to see you.
Good to be back home.
See you in Arizona, if not sooner. So, all right, well, guess what? Robin Larson is our winner, and the Van Prix hero is going to have some words with him. Andrew Coley, down to you with our winner, Robin Larson.
Sorry to interrupt, Robin. Congratulations, dude. Well done.
Yeah, nice. Good comeback from yesterday. So, like I said, it's been a roller coaster over the weekend. So, nice to close the gap to Kevin. He had a really strong weekend, but to come out on top, it always feels nice. So, good points.
Great tactics for you. Didn't work out so well for Andreas. It doesn't look like he took his choker lap, so we think he's going to be dropping down the order.
Yeah, I saw that when they waved in the white flag, and he still continues, so I was a little bit shocked. The start was perfect, and I could go without any harm on anyone in the start into the joker, so I was like, let's do this. Then could just nail the laps, but it's hard in the dark, but for once this day, I could be the one in the back and just analyze where Kevin and the backward struggled. So it was so slippery on some spots, so it was nice to be the guy finally who could analyze out the guys. I don't think Kevin pushed the maximum and do something stupid when he's in the position he is. So a really good weekend for him.
Well done, mate. It's a classic rally track to win at. Yeah, it's the G track, isn't it? The OG track for Nitrocross. Well done.
Thank you.
Well, here we are in the family room, joined by second and third place. Some fans coming over here, grabbing some autographs from Kevin Erickson. Finishes second place. I gotta fast forward over here, Kevin. I know you're gonna scrutinize your own run, but Tanner Faust, man, welcome to Nitrocross FC1X. Your first time whipping it around, and here you are getting on the box. Robin Larson joining us as well. Tanner, third place, and we'll go up back second to first.
Thanks. Yeah, age before beauty. I get it. No, it's all good. Whatever. Yesterday not making the final was pretty disappointing. It'd been a while since that happened, I think, but it was so cool to get this car dialed in. We worked really hard with Ollie Bennett and the guys, and getting we made a huge number of changes overnight, which is kind of a big gamble.
Yeah.
Right off in the beginning in the warm-up, the car was quick. Still, I can't keep up with these guys on the tarmac, and there's probably a lot to do there, but I'm just glad to be in the race and not off the back. And you know, you can't even tell on screen how big these jumps are, how hard these guys are pushing, how fine the line is. So a lot of respect for what everybody's doing in this series.
Well, you say these guys, you're one of them now. You're going to hold Nitrocross medal. Kevin, let's take a look. Walk us through again. You're the harshest critic on yourself. Second place, congratulations. But silver there for Kevin Erickson. Let's take a look here at the final. We'll get to you, Robin. I know you had some words there with Coley. How about this start? Kevin, what's going through your mind? You know, you're up there on that front row.
I was so surprised. There were so many track markers missing all of a sudden in the final. So everywhere we could kind of drive different, and caught me off guard slightly. But felt good. Obviously, it is good for, you know, I see Robin now get first into the Yorker. I am disappointed, though I shouldn't really be, but I did have some more if, you know, really, really could use, you know, but if you risk it. But, I, you know, in the front, you can't really risk it either. So, congrats to Robin, but I really wanted to win today.
Yeah, and you know, Casper Janssen says all bets were on you. You know, Travis came in here. He says Kevin is just such a threat. His money was Andreas, you know, admittedly. Travis said Andreas, and we said, you know, you're Mr. Go around the outside, but you had this amazing pass earlier today on the inside. I think that just showed the breadth of your work and how you can manipulate this vehicle. This track really seemed to suit your style. Obviously, not the best because somebody beat you here tonight, but overall, I think this track suited you well, and we talked about the gravel, the tarmac, all those things. Track's pretty exciting.
For sure it was. I see I have quite a good gap here on Robin, so Robin must have put some really good laps in, but yeah, it was really nice to be here, good crowd. Obviously being back here, this is the first track I drove in Nitro, and I will never forget that day I did the first gap jump, and it was kind of that feeling again now, but I wanted to win today. But also good to see Tanner back, someone, you know, me as a kid, I watched him drive for my father's team, so
it's
fun to race him.
Here's a shovel.
Why you feel old?
I tell you, hey, look, I'm not here to perpetuate that, but I did take a picture with the girl today. I was like, yeah, sure, and she's like, it's for my dad.
Okay.
Your dad was there. Andreas was there, and he's like, "You made my night. Thank you."
Brilliant. Kevin, you were leading the championship coming into the finals, I think, by some 20 points, thanks to the top qualifier early on today. So I'm pretty sure you'd still be leading the standings. You know, you're going away from here with some great pace and great results and definitely a better start than last season.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that time I had a broken leg and got run over by a car, so I shouldn't, you know. And the pace, I'm very happy with today. But, you know, today I was just focused and I wanted to win. It didn't really matter. The win was the thing, but yeah.
Hey, mate, do you want to join us? Come, have a seat. Have a seat over here. Andreas Backer has just walked in. Grab that mic and we'll have a chat with you. Mate, what happened?
I was behind Kevin there and I was just thinking Joker opposite and I got the call Joker opposite. So I went normal line and tried to push as hard as I could to take the Joker the next lap and coming over to check your flag. I couldn't understand anything and there's no one to blame because there's part the drivers, the spotter, the team. So it's part of Rallycross, really. I've done this before. This is not my first time. It's not going to be my last time, but it's a bummer. I felt I've been solid, probably solid P2 all weekend after Kevin. And then I don't know what Robin had for dinner, but it surely paid off.
Ollie Bennett's just walked in, Tanner Powell's teammate. So, Ollie, that's a decent signing for the weekend, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, he's welcome back. We've been a good team this weekend. It's been a lot of fun, and to get on the podium's great. So, yeah, great weekend.
Nice one. Tanner, you've enjoyed it?
Oh, yeah, I mean, so fun. I'll be honest, when we did the track walk, I mean, the jumps are massive. The gap jump has historically had a fairly soft landing, but it's a spectacle. The other jumps are the ones that I worry about for the big landings. Yeah. And honestly, these cars land so well. Andreas Eriksson did a job on these cars, making them suit what the American tracks were starting to look like with big jumps. So they're ridiculously fast, they jump well, and there wasn't a dust issue for the final. It was an awesome race. I had a lot of fun, really.
So you're a bit more experienced now than the two laps you had when you came here after the Race of Champions, where you'd like to come back and do some more?
Yeah, I didn't know. Honestly, yesterday I had no idea where the buttons were. I was pushing the wiper button instead of the boost button, the radio button instead of something else.
Too many buttons.
I downshifted on the straightaway. I was pushing all the wrong buttons yesterday. Today, I knew where it was, which helped a lot, but I mean, honestly, these guys are fast.
Can I ask, did you podium?
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, man.
Yeah. I've also skipped a joker or two. It happens.
Yeah, I mean, Travis said he remembers that when Dave Mirra did that. And here it is, the fastest lap, Robin Larson, 1:15. It came together for you in the final. So, Robin Larson, without further ado, here it is, your first place trophy for round 3 Nitro Cross here in Utah. Make some noise for Robin Larson. Again, provisionally. You know, officially, we'll see. There's some things coming. We were like, again, we were just baffled, man. Travis was here in the booth with us. I'm not, you know, they're focusing on you. I was like, let's focus on what's going on here. It was a crazy race. This whole weekend, this track is really insane.
Yeah. I've said it. There's three big ones, right? There is Loyac in France, there's Hollies in Sweden, and there's Salt Lake, the OG track here. I've won 2 of the 3, and I couldn't take it this time.
Mate.
Next year, I'll be back.
Just gotta take the Joker, you know?
Where's the camera?
Yeah.
I'll be back. There?
Hey, this one. I'll be back. That one there.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that was really intimidating.
I'm very Terminator-esque.
Yeah,
right?
Wow. Boo.
Heavy.
I'm scared. Robin, what's that? Oh, yeah, awards time. So let's take a look at different accolades here of either, you know, big jumps, passes, moments. So what do we have first? We have the My Energy Best Pass. The My Energy Best Pass. Which one do we have? Ollie Eriksson with the best pass. And here we go. Flapping the hood, goes in the side of the 42, fights back, and then goes and gets into it. Ollie joining us here. Ollie, you didn't have the best finale there, but what's up?
He just pointed out, Jared, he had a left front puncture when he made the pass, so that's fair enough.
There and he got the flop.
On the rim, so it was fine.
Ironically, he's sitting right in front of Ollie Bennett right now, too. Ironic. All right. So here's the big air moment. Brought to you by Rumble. Be sure to download the app now. And it's the second car. I believe it's, who's that, Travis? Travis Pastrana going huge. landing that. We the People holsters. Savage for him vehicle, and here it is. Travis Pastrana with the biggest air. I think we'd all agree Connor Daly maybe holds a world record for the longest jump, unofficially 180 feet in an EV.
183. Yeah, right here, said it.
Don't you have the record in a trophy track?
I used to have the record in a four-wheel vehicle, okay. But I don't anymore, okay. Bryce Menzies. But yeah, 100. I don't think there was an EV record, but that has to be the longest EV jump of all time.
We need, like in Rally Finland, you know, we have the boards for the landing so we can start to judge the legs.
Yeah. Well, again, just such a great festivity here this weekend. We saw wind, we saw rain, we saw lightning even as Connor Martell jumped. We saw two different victors. We have a new points leader leaving this round of competition. You know, Kevin Erickson fought for it. You know, Pastrana got the win yesterday, but Erickson leading the pack after last night, so he should be obviously holding on to that lead. Backroot chopping things up a little bit as well. We'll get the official results. Travis was saying it's just a 5-second delay. You're not in the back of the pack unofficially. You'll just drop to fourth. We'll find that out. Fraser McConnell, Jamaican flags. I don't know if we're in Jamaica or in America right now, Fraz, with all the flags your mom put around here.
Yeah, man, we're coloring up the place with some you know, the prettiest flag. You know, I love America. God bless America, but we brought the real thing, you know?
Big ups, green, yellow,
tough
black.
Weekend, but, you know, congrats to these guys. Everyone drove their heart out. And, you know, big up to Utah for hosting us, awesome fans, and, yeah, looking for a better result next time.
Good to Absolutely. See you with a smile on your face again, mate. Yeah. Decent fight back, you know, the next round.
It was a tough weekend for sure, but, you know, these ones build character, and if it was easy, everyone would do it, so.
Coley, any closing thoughts here as far as round two, round three? We'll see you in Arizona.
I think we've got to look at the fact people have been having good and bad days, like lots of people. The championship, we're a long way from the end of it, and everybody is on a very similar pace. I think we're in for a cracking season. And for me, coming back to where I first joined Nitro back in 2018 at this incredible track with these guys, I've never seen a track make so many drivers so nervous as this one does. Yeah. And to come back has just been fantastic. What a great weekend.
Including yourself with the Van Prix.
Dude.
And there it is. Coley drinks hot dog water. That's it. Vilko's going to get that tattooed on his bottom end that he showed you guys as you started. And look at that blazing start.
You need to practice on the reaction time, Coley.
I just want to try a different car, but yeah, it wasn't the best, was it? James. Even he got back past me. Yeah. Come on, man. I need more than one gear, you know? More than one gear, please, next time. I should have tested the car yesterday, shouldn't I?
They set you up, Coley.
Yeah, it's funny, well, being around the world of rallycross, Andrew here, he's like, I'm quite a racer myself, doing rally, being instructor in rally schools and stuff. I mean, what is that?
No, it's one gear. I'm going to take you on. We're going to have a race somewhere, you and me. It's going down. We'll pick a vehicle. I mean, I don't think I'm quite ready for the FC1, but you know.
I'm not driving those things.
No.
Payment isn't that good.
Dude, oh, dude. Yeah.
The next final, we saw some great racing with the Olsbergs racer, Casper Janssen. A lot of eyeballs on Leah Block. Great to see her just outside of podium finish. Side by sides, really exciting.
That's Kira.
The TR camp really wanted that. He's got second place at all the previous rounds. Finally got the win. He really wanted it. We're going to see him the entirety of the season. Side by sides, again, the Baja Buggies, really awesome there to see those vehicles. But of course, Group B, 1,000 horsepower, FC1X. All-wheel drive, absolutely exciting for the entirety of the season. Really great racing, great tracks, looking forward to Arizona. Robin, you're looking real stoic right now. You're quiet, are you exhausted?
It's been a long weekend, long days, and it's been tough. But it's like so hard to predict what's gonna come in next heat. So it's just, it's been a hell of a weekend, and Kevin's been really strong, so I'm really relieved to get a win and still be pretty good in the championship.
Awesome. Well, get some rest or grab a monster because maybe you're going to party tonight here in Salt Lake. Congratulations, Robin Larson. You're winning here round three. Congratulations to everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. On behalf of Andrew Coley, all the racers, Diana Dahlgren, we'll see you in Arizona. That's a wrap on round two and three here at Utah Motorsports Campus. This is Nitro Cross. We'll see you online or we'll see you another time. Send it, Nitro Cross Nation.
Let's get ready to send it. Nitro Cross is cars that fly and tracks that thrill.
This is motocross with the Wolfies.
We're talking dirt track, bigger jump.
Don't doubt us. Believe in it.
Oh, Erickson rolls!
Don't tell your mom we're gonna go bigger.
Let's go!